Well, let's see. There we go. Some sound. Oh, the air be's cold. A flake in white, a sailor begs their pledge. To the ice they'll pray that leads reveal. Out in the ice they'll stake a claim that in the dark they'll brace themselves. Oh, the airs be cold, a flake in white, as a sailor begs their pledge. To the ice they'll pray that leads reveal some charted course ahead. Of homes they'll dream to the souls around, or of glory found. Of homes they'll dream of warmth long lost and chased to Frostworld's edge. A hunger draws the desperate year. It's one that can't be fed. Such lonely souls need lead. Its calling soothes the spread. It's one that can't be fed. What will you do when steel hearts break and courage does abscond? I'll lead these souls, so help the gods. I'll do what must be done indeed. I'll learn to live a life out here. Of it here, out in the pale beyond. Alright. Begin your journey. Let's go. Let's see what different decisions we can make here, chat. You're alone in the office. The tea in your hand has long since been cold. It's perfectly adequate. I would definitely rather have coffee. I don't like tea. Fuck tea. Blue Fairy, this is Bellulars' new game. Looking around the room, you can make out a collection of military books. On the desk is a ship in a bottle. A metronome ticks away steadily. I find it rather calming. Might want to move the camera? Oh yeah, you guys can't actually fuck. Okay, never mind. Well, wait, let me see. Dude, this is so weird. But hold up. We'll move myself here. That shouldn't interfere, right? Shouldn't. I hope. So we'll put me here for now. We can't fuck? Not right now. I find it rather calming. The dedicated rhythm soothes the senses. The room is sweltering, the air stiff and stale. Keep waiting. You hear footsteps climbing the stairs that brought you here. Take a seat. The chair is uncomfortably large, the seat feels worn. The door behind you swings open. The captain bounds past you to the other side of the desk. Do you have all your teeth? Sorry? Answer the question, please. I've not had scurvy before. If that's what you're asking. Me neither. Okay, thanks, Captain. Really appreciate that. The captain sits down. How many people have died under your supervision? I don't appreciate this line of questioning. I don't appreciate this line of questioning. You will when you're on the ice. Alright, just don't push me for it. I think I've lost a lot of people. If I was an actual captain, I would probably lose a lot of people. I'm Captain Hunt. Sure. He nods. On your desk, which ship is that? Ah, this. Detailed, isn't she? Incredibly. An old sailor's superstition. I hope you weren't waiting too long. Is this a waste of my time? We're skipping through this because we obviously saw it yesterday with Bellulars stream. So I'm just sort of going through this a bit faster just so we can get to the actual places where we get to make some decisions. There's been a lot of candidates. Some good, some bad. Interesting mix. Shinshimu, sadly we can't fuck. Like they did say yesterday that there's no fucking mechanics in the game. For some reason, there is just none. I'm sure you understand the need for discretion. The advert said there was glory to be had. Months of darkness, low wages, slim chance of safe return. That didn't deter you, didn't it? Did it? Quite the opposite. That's why I'm here. A waste, sex is a good exercise to warm. Well, true, but if you want your game to actually be playable by most people, then maybe you shouldn't add 6 to your game, you know? I played this 2.5 years ago. Aureus, how could you have played this 2.5 years ago? He winks. I'd keep that to myself around the other sailors. They might drown you in it. Few questions first. He looks down at his list of questions. Were you born a landlubber or sea dog? If I knew, I'd tell you. I've been all over. The ocean. Game needs an in-game shop. Hagabun, fuck off. Fuck off, what are you saying? Until you're covered in sweat and getting cold from it. military experience? Are we military men or are we merchants? I feel like I'm a military man. I'm in the military, definitely. Or loot boxes, those would be cool. Oh yeah, can you imagine? The story can only continue if you get the right loot box. That would be really cool. We criminals, degenerates? No. If we're criminals, we might not get on the fucking ship. Under what circumstances did you leave in one piece? Yep. You'd be surprised when he can't even say that. Have you ever fired a weapon? Yes. Have you ever killed a man, directly or otherwise? Yes. I see. You're not married, are you? Of course not. You better not have a death wish. One must believe they'll return to justify leaving in the first place. We're criminals, let's be real. Yes, but we're... What stupid fucking criminal tells his future employer that he's a criminal? We're lying, chat. We're lying to them. You have to keep your fucking wits about you. Do you think Jack the Ripper would have gotten away with the murders if he was just telling everyone he's Jack the Ripper? Of course not. Any less than you're doing yourself a disservice. Where are we headed? You're only a criminal if you get caught. True. We're here to find the ship in that bottle. The Viscount. Heard of it? No, enlighten me. He clears his throat. 5 years ago, she set sail on a research expedition towards the Dead Peninsula. They were trying to find and study the absolute magnetic south. Did they? Did they what? Did they find it? Magnetic south? Did they complete their research? Just get to the point, old man. Fuck. I have no idea. She never came back. Her last known location was two... Oh, that's very loud. Should I turn it down a little bit, guys? Yeah, I'll turn it down a little bit because that is quite loud for background. Let's see. Is that better? Or do you want it down even more? Last known location was 200 miles south of land, presumed lost to the ice. 5 years is a bit late for a rescue operation. They're probably dead. Yeah, that seems like something I would say. Alive or not, their research is supposedly of extreme importance. And we're supposed to be chasing that research? Exactly. I'm going to need more than rumors about lost ships if I'm putting my life at risk. All right, you have my attention. When you tabbed out, sound was gone, but this is a good level. Immersive, yet not intrusive. All right, then that's what we'll do. Yeah, obviously, the game is weird. Like, it's in windowed mode, Alex, but it's not in windowed mode. This is Bellulars Game Classics, yes. The captain smiles. Here's what we know. Not one person or thing has been heard from the Viscount since it first left port. So we're chasing ghosts then. They're definitely all dead. Maybe it's a myth. Maybe it isn't. I can assure you the money is real. Those with more money than sense want that old ship. That's the job. If I don't pick the first mate, somebody else will. And, well, my judge of character's gotten me this far. What of our crew? What of our own ship? And who's financing all of this? Let's see. The usual, film and lecture rights have been sold, of course. We're in the process of signing off on a final benefactor for the expedition. But we're running like WoW's audio, where you have to tick a box to allow it to run when minimized. Not that I could see. So we go settings here. Sound. Gameplay. Yeah, no. Whatever the fuck it is, it's not working. They've even donated a ship. We'll be traveling on board the Temperance. She's a beauty. Greenwood generational. Not many like it left these days. The Viscount and the Temperance. They're sister ships. Both together. They don't have it added. I'm just talking about the back end. I really hope that they will add it. Blasphemous Crow, take care of yourself, brother. Thank you so much for hanging out, man. Sent out into this world to die alone. What does that matter? Perhaps it's just me. But I like to think one calls out for the other. The captain looks at the bottled ship. So what do you think? It's worth it if there's a chance anyone's alive. Sounds like you'll be needing all the help you can get. When can I start? That sounds like me. Horror! Not many are as eager as you. Captain checks his watch. Anyway, I think I've heard enough. Captain stands up. We leave in a month. Welcome aboard, Shaw. Proverbially speaking. Don't you need more information? So I have the job? What do you think? I'll see you on the Temperance. The captain makes his way out the door, and you follow. You arrive at the docks a month to the day. Before you lies a ship, the letters on the side spelling Temperance. Approach the Temperance. You walk the cobble to the boarding ramp. Beside is a sharply dressed man, overseeing the loading of cargo. Hello, sir. He turns to you with a stern expression. You can feel his eyes assessing you. A military gait. You must be Hunt's pick for first mate. I figured he'd keep it in the ranks. Good man. He extends an arm. Richard Templeton, a pleasure. You accept his offer of a handshake. It's a considerate shake. What the hell is a considerate shake? I shall be operating as chief science officer on this expedition. I am also the incumbent representative of our benefactor. Do, however, consider myself and my team at you and the captain's disposal. Accepting handshake during COVID? Yikes. Dude, there's no COVID here. This is like way before COVID was even a thing. What did you specialize in? Mr. Templeton, I look forward to working together. I'm fairly certain we're all disposable. He straightens himself. No doubt I needn't inform you of your duties. You're second only to Captain Hunt himself. Though I must warn you that you have quite the task ahead. The rabble I've spent the afternoon sorting are the same that you'll have to whip into shape. Punctuality, schedule, a strict adherence to what we need if this expedition is to succeed. I expect you to be the organized sort. You would not have been assigned the role otherwise. I likely have more in common with the crew than I do yourself, Mr. Templeton. I have more than enough experience with a crew of this nature. You speak like you're in charge. It sounds pretty nice now. Handshake can tell a lot about what a person thinks of. Adrian, true, but what is a considered shake? What does that even mean? Considered shake. I have no fucking clue what that is. This is comforting to hear. It would seem for most of the crew, the captain favored personal history over expertise. It is good to know he found the capable sort for such a vital role. Let me know when you're ready to depart. I'm certain you're eager to get back on the ocean. The less valuable time we waste here, the better. Means respect, yet confident? Ah. Well, fuck him. Jesus. You'll be gone for quite a while. It will be some time before you see the city again. Well, who's this young man? A young man stands at the ramp, steeling himself for the journey ahead. Hesitantly, he begins to drag his feet up the ramp and onto the ship. All right. I don't think we can pan yet, can we? No. The Temperance. Hunt's description of the ship was accurate. Near identical to the Viscount, barring some modern additions. All right, are we ready to fucking set sail, ladies and gentlemen? Week one. Dominance, I like a boss that likes his employees. Yeah, but I'm supposed to be the boss. First mate Shaw, personal log. It's been a month. It's been a month since I signed on, and 1 week since we've set sail aboard the Temperance. I'm told the waters still will get warmer as we pass the hemisphere before they turn colder. Who's paying for this? I can't help but wonder who's footing the bill for all this. Certainly not the captain. I should investigate further. I intend to investigate further. The Admiralty had nothing like this. She's magnificent. A technical marvel, elegant machinery, expertly weaved through one of the fastest hardwood ships of its day. Reborn for this mission, breathing again with life. She's simply magnificent. As for its master, he's mostly kept to his quarters so far. I'm not sure what to make of our leader. I need to know if I can trust Captain Hunt. I'm not sure what to make of our leader. He's impulsive. He's not telling the whole truth. I've heard the rumors. Drinking. Desertion. There's probably a good reason he's dressed in antiques. Need to cook food. Have fun, dude. Is that a wooden ship with a chimney? Danmaku, yeah, it's sort of the old steamships. It's like in that era where steamships probably were a thing. Perhaps I'm too quick to judge. I mustn't let my guard down. Despite that, I find myself warming to the man. Enigmatic indeed. I mustn't let my guard down. As for the rest of the crew, there are now 22 of us, including the captain. Our next port will be our last before we enter the ice, to pick up the remaining 4 members of the crew, the scouting team. Hunt is also keen to work out a deal on a pack of sledding dogs. The crew are a strange lot. I've sailed with worse. They smell terrible. They smell terrible, though I'm told it will soon be too cold on the ice to smell anything at all. Sign off. One of Hunt's sailors approaches. Captain! What, Captain wants you at the helm. Good. I want to see him. I'll head there now. What for? He's gone. Execute Order 69. What the fuck is Order 69, Evans? He leaves. Alright. What the hell is forecastle? The forecastle door appears to be locked. The door to the Hunt's cabin is shut tight. The captain himself is busy at the helm. Alright, so I can't go there yet. You ascend the stairs to the stern and find the old captain manning the helm of the ship. Ah, Robin, lovely day for it, isn't it? It is indeed, Captain. One of your lackeys summoned me. Don't you have a helmsman to do that for you? Not the Padawans? Don't you have a helmsman to do that for you? Of course I do, but it's good to keep the old skills sharp. Never know when you're going to have to get your hands dirty. Alex may be gone, but you guys know Alpaca is still here. He thinks for a moment before stepping aside and stretching out a wrinkled hand. Did you ever take the helm in the Admiralty? Here, why don't you have a try? Take the wheel. You grip the wheel of the ship and feel the weight of the waves in your arms. If memory and your muscles rear themselves as you begin to move in time with the ship and the wind. Right. Easy. There, you have it. Captain pats you on the back. Fantastic. Now try to get a sense of where we are. Get some perspective. Zoom is a little bit slow, but still. The game looks really good, though, doesn't it? I never thought I would actually like this kind of art style, but I do. Can this baby drift? I don't know. Panning and zooming speeds can be adjusted in the settings menu. He takes the wheel back from you. I think I'll drink the morning in a little longer. Would you mind preparing my quarters for the day's work? There's much to do. Consequently applied. Let's hope they're careful with the mechanical stoker. It looks quite lovely. I like the feel of it is really cool. A painting. A classical painting depicting sailors doing battle with a kraken. Saltborn. An ode to an old folk story of the great Captain Seamus's dance with the Salt Kings. A pristine furnished tub secured to the floor. A luxury to be had on the ice. On the desk, you make out a variety of papers, notes, and maps, as well as a sealed letter with a stamp you don't recognize. The desk itself is suspended with ropes to keep it safely in place. Take requests. Here we go. You take a seat at the end of the room. The captain joins you. Niara, how you doing? Now, let's run through our provisions before taking requests. To start, there's 23 souls signed onto this expedition, ourselves included. That's 16 free to be assigned to tasks, and the rest deployed to their permanent stations. You are only able to deploy crew you have discovered. They must be in good health and not otherwise deployed to another post. Yes, this is Bellulars game. We'll be picking up the scouting crew at next port. A lot of us also seem to be in good spirits. The expedition will tear itself apart if you end the week with no decorum left. So this is decorum, this is our food. We have enough provisions for at least 6 months in case of emergency. Crew members will start to develop scurvy and be unable to work should you end the week with no food left in the hoshpot. And more than enough fuel to see us there and back again. You will all freeze to death if you end the week with no fuel in the furnace. The sledding dogs, well, they're still a matter of negotiation. Dogs will be needed to send sledding teams out to gather resources on the ice. Now, on to work. All right, here we go. As long as Balila doesn't narrate it himself, I don't think he will. Gives me that good old point-and-click adventure games like Monkey Island. Pretty much, that's what I said when we were watching it last night. It feels like those old detective games. I used to play a shit ton of like the early Sherlock Holmes games. The Jack the Ripper game was very much like this. What else? There's a couple of other games as well. The what was it called again? Something Christie. The fuck is those games? What are they called again? Christie. She's an actual writer. Like, she writes these kind of stories. Agatha Christie, that's the one. Thank you. Yes. I played, there's three Agatha Christie games as well, and they're all like this. You click stuff, and you do stuff as you click it. I fucking love games like this. All right, Corvid, in you come. A sailor enters. We found a stowaway in the lower hold. Bring them in. Another sailor enters, leading a young man by their side. You know, you're not the first stowaway I've had. The captain studies them further. You know where we're heading, don't you?
I do, sir. The ice.
Do you know that before you climbed inside that crate?
I did, sir.
Har, how old are you? You're hardly a useful pair of hands.
There's a detective game on the Nintendo with graphics like this, similar gameplay, and it's fun.
I don't have a Nintendo, but I love games like this. Just playing this makes me want to go back and play some of the Agatha Christie games. Have you played The Return of the Obra Dinn?
No, I have not.
What's it about?
Not true. I can pull my own weight, sir.
Do you know your Jaboom from your bowsprit?
I do. I learned it all from my Da.
Your Da? He's Ward's son. Followed him on board back in the city. What should we do with him, Captain?
I used to read Agatha books with my parents. It was a funny time.
Dude, the games for Agatha Christie is really cool. Like, the detective games. Really awesome. Hunt eyes you up. Your first mate, what should we do with him? I keep them aboard. He's not staying on board. It's your decision to make, not mine. Let's keep him. The more the merrier. I'd keep them aboard. Hunt squints. Why? You need all the help you can get. This young man wants to help. He's clearly here because his father is. It would be wrong to separate them again. We don't have the time to accommodate this. If the boy wants to freeze to death, let him. That's just Siberia. Nice game. Too bad the writer passed away after writing the fourth. If you like narrative games like this, try Suzerain. It's fun. I've never heard of it. You should. It's essentially you trying to piece up what happened on a ship where everyone died by going back in time and seeing very short scenes where people die. You need to identify the crew members and how they died exactly. That actually sounds really cool. Fuck. Would adding him to the crew be a further drain on resources? Yes, it is going to be. All right, boy, consider yourself part of the crew. Be sure to keep your nose clean and follow orders.
I will, thank you, sir.
Captain, not sir. Aye, Captain. Stowaway joins the two sailors below deck, now a member of the crew. Well, it seems the litter has a new runt. I hope the rest won't mind sharing their rations. What of the father? Simple. Split their pay and their rations. Any rations the boy takes should come from ease. I doubt he intended for this to happen. We'll keep an eye on them both.
Oh, this is...
Yeah, I don't think we should split their rations. That's just gonna lead to two people having fucking scurvy.
Independent game on Steam?
I doubt he intended for this to happen. We'll keep an eye on them both. I suppose you're right. Well, that matter's sorted. All right, Cordal, what do you have for me? Have you agreed upon my conditions? To the point, eh? Sure, this is Lady Cordal. Cordalia is to provide us with a kennel of hounds for the sleds, and our agreement was that she would train them up until we part ways at the nearest island, but... You neglected to inform me that you were bringing my dogs through the Pale Passage. I had no intention of sending the pack to its death. If they cut the ration of them, we make extra moral strands that maybe bite us later. Well, Amon, yeah, that's why I'm not going to do that. Because not just is going to be a moral issue later on, but it could also be, like, if they develop scurvy, you lose two fucking soldiers in the sailors in the process. But no intention of sending this pack to their death. You seem to have good faith in this expedition. It's one thing to ask for my whole kennel. It's another to drag them into the ice to chase a myth. Never before has a buyer been so dishonest. And never before has a seller made such strong demands. And what exactly are these demands? You already sold the dogs, did you not? You have no control over them now. She demands we allow her to come along on the expedition as a member of the crew. None on this ship have the experience and familiarity with these dogs that I possess. If you are taking them to such a brutal location, they will need me to guide them if they have any chance of survival. The humans on board too, of course. Of course. You can see my dilemma, sure. We've just accepted a stowaway. Bringing on another member of the crew is a risk, but our hands may be tied. Your thoughts? I don't see the harm in having an expert on slate dogs. We should cancel the deal. We can find another buyer. If you're so adamant, we accept your offer. More miles to feed? Well, I think we can get more food later on. We could, like, dude, we're on a fucking boat. We'll just fish. Easy. It's not a problem. We'll figure it out. You can't decide that yourself, sure. You aren't the captain. But you are right. I doubt Lady Cordal is likely to give up in her demands. He turns to her. This deal is already to your benefit.
Do you have anyone on board with extensive training in the management and ruling of dogs? Your sleds are useless if you can't control the dogs efficiently enough to haul them.
Nahomi, how you doing?
Oh, crap. Experts on hand has its upsides.
I don't think food is fixed. Because you can send out people for resources, so I'm assuming food is fucking resource, right? If you can't send people out for food, then we're fucked. Basically, we've screwed ourselves at the beginning of the game already.
Welcome aboard, Caudal. Your knowledge should prove valuable.
Invaluable?
I'll have a room prepared for you below deck. No need. You'll find me in the forecastle with the dogs.
Oh shit, she's just sleeping with the dogs.
I hope I'm not making mistakes, Sean.
Finish the request.
Now that that's all settled, I have one more errand for you to run. Could you grab the Stoke brothers and order them to meet me up on deck after dinner? Hefty lads, red hair, you could have mistaken them for another.
The Stoke brothers? Who are they?
The Stoke brothers, who are they? She starts her job immediately. Nice to hear. Yeah, but would you sleep in the kennel with all the dogs for the whole of the journey, though? I mean, it's going to smell fucking rancid in there. It might be hot because dogs are fucking hot. So it's probably like one of the nicest places to be in. But the whole time, that's your bed. That's where you sleep. That would be rough.
Bad luck to have a woman and a stowaway in a single damn voyage.
Is it bad luck? Superstition takes priest. Take priest. We're not the superstitious kind.
On a boat with livestock?
You haven't met all the crew yet. The Stokes have been serving me for years. They'll be down in the middle deck. In the meantime, you should grab a copy of the crew manifest and get acquainted with more of the crew.
Right. Let's grab this.
At least you're warm.
Yeah, but you also smell like shit. Upon closer inspection, you make out the ship's photographer, Kasha Balford, balanced on the ship's mast with her camera, lining up for a photo.
Get down immediately, you'll kill yourself.
How's the view up there? Wait for her to finish.
You startle the woman, causing her to fall and nearly drop her camera.
Let's help her down.
You help her retrieve the device and untangle herself from the rigging.
That was a close shave, Officer Shaw.
It's about time I met the first officer of this ship.
You're assuming the guys won't smell like shit, not being able to bathe often enough?
I mean, you're surrounded by water. You could technically bathe as often as you fucking want.
Just go to East DSR clear. First stream run, as far as I know.
Is what clear?
But you also don't know the other seamen, so both could have its upsides or not. Better have an eye for the situation.
Dude, you can warm up the fucking water, can you not? No one said you should just get the water out of the ocean and splash it on yourself. Like, grab a couple of buckets full, put it down in the steam room, let it heat up, and then bam, nice little warm-ish water for you to fucking bath in. Can fuck you up. So salt water will kill you when you swim in it? Or when you bath in it? How is salt water gonna kill you? Or fuck you up?
Alicia, how you doing?
Dude, so you're telling me if you bath in salt water, that will kill you? Are you guys just fucking trolling right now? Am I being trolled? Is chat being completely and utterly psychotic right now? There are people who swim in the ocean consistently and nothing fucking happens to them. But if you bath in the ocean, no, you'll die. You'll fucking die, bro. Chat. I need you to lift your IQ by at least 20 points here.
Deep sea divers frequently die of salt-induced dehydration.
Yeah, but no one said drank the fucking water.
If they can bathe in the water, so can the gull. Only if you drink it, because saltwater pools exist. Contains tiny knives. Yeah, okay, so it's all going to just kill you. So it's actually good for the skin.
No one said drink the fucking salt water. Yes, I've heard of you already. Nice to meet you, Kasha. I suppose there was some sort of rule against what I was doing. Deepest apologies, but sometimes there's a shot you just cannot pass up. An accomplished photographer, Kasia Balfour, won the Faintler Prize, the highest honor in journalism, for her work covering plague outbreaks and riots in the capital. DSR equals Dragon Song Reprise, the newest ultimate. He just got his clear less than half an hour. Is that the world first? Came as no surprise to many that such a reputable journalist would take such an interest in this expedition. There was scarcely any chance of Hunt or the benefactor turning her way. Rockman, you bastard! Thanks for the 2 months up. Did really appreciate that. 2 months in a row.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
First stream run. Ah, in my opinion, better look out how these things work out. The smell is a moral thing we need to sort out in due time. I don't know if this game is actually going to let people be angry about smell. You expected someone of her accolades to be older, more experienced. This is likely her first time on the sea like this. She's not prepared for this. Her proof is all we have. Her accomplishments surely outweigh her youth. Inexperience is a matter of interest, but her accolades speak for themselves. The cold game. Picture that as a header. What? For the piece on this voyage, I'm trying to come up with a snappy name. Nobody will read it if the title sounds like the work of an amateur. Sounds fine to me. I like it. I'm not the creative type. I'm sure you'd know better. I'm a military man. I will blow up this ice. That's what I do. This voyage is cursed. We even have a total novice to the sea aboard. Dude, trust in me. I am an experienced military sailor. I will get these grunts through this and done. You don't have to worry about it. This is a bug, right? I'm pretty sure this is a bug. It should not be like this. I'll do a screenshot of this. Never mind. There we go. We'll do a screenshot of this. Fuck. Okay, here we go. I'll report this to Bellulars later, but I'm pretty sure this is a bug. Yeah, I'm not the creative type. I'm sure you know better. Kasia tilts her head and grits her teeth, holding an inner debate with herself. Maybe not. How about Hunt's incredible voyage? Too fantastical? I suppose I'll find the right name when the time comes. I'm getting ahead of myself, aren't I? Apologies. I'm just a little excited. I've never been on a voyage like this. Rockman, very good in you, bro. How you doing? I suppose someone of your expertise finds it all boring at this point. A trip to the ice may seem dull compared to the Royal Admiralty. You know who I am? I was thinking that it was just didn't want to seem like an ass because I couldn't develop a game like this. Kendrickman, what do you mean? Someone save the dude at the top? Yeah, she just keeps falling. This is not good. Of course, I thoroughly researched the crew of the Temperance. May seem somewhat excessive, but I feel it's necessary for a proper chronicling. That, and plenty of pictures. Don't worry, Shaw. You don't have a reputation that sets you apart from the rest. A celebrity like Kurt Darling's presence will dwarf any rumors that could form around you. That reminds me, he'll be joining us at next port. I should get his picture at some point. Kasia holds up her camera with a sense of pride before holding it up to her face. Stand still, Shaw. Please warn me before doing that. That was another bug. There was literally no flash whatsoever. But I think they might have removed it because I don't think they've added any epilepsy warnings or anything to the game yet. So that might be why. They've always wanted you to point out bugs to them. That's how games are fixed. True. Like, bugs is a good thing to point out. Please warn me before doing that. A camera like that doesn't have a flash. It's too old. It had a flash yesterday, Blue Fairy. It did have a flash yesterday. Don't worry. I tell you, if I have it, then... Rim the Weirdo. Thanks for the tier one sub. Did really appreciate that. 3 months in a row. 21 months altogether. Bro, really appreciate that. Thank you.
I stole the ARR since I skipped it my first time through, FF14, and I absolutely love it my second time around.
Because you fucking skipped it, you moron. Rim the Weirdo. Don't live up to your name, please. Don't skip shit again. Just play the fucking game the way that it's supposed to be played, please. And don't talk too much about Final Fantasy XIV, because I'm sitting here playing this and actually enjoying it, but also at the same time thinking, I really want to free Alamigo.
Oh, sorry. It's for the manifest Hunt wanted me to put together for you. She hands you an annotated document. Here it is, the crew manifest.
So we have the run. We have Joseph Joe Green. We have Killian Smith Sanders and Emilia Colvett Sparrow. No scouts yet, no engineers yet, no scientists yet, and the specialists. And then resources and key items. Right. How do I... Okay, there we go. It's a work in progress. The scout team are to join us at the next port, and the captain's forbidden me from the lowest deck. If you could ask the others to get their porters taken, I'd be very grateful. Don't want to leave anyone out. Thank you, Kasha. She smiles. I'll not disturb you off your work any further, officer. I have a few more shots I want to get before the sun lowers, anyhow. Safe shots, officer. Don't worry. You leave her to her work.
But to see the new things is always nice. Expedition is its own price.
Wait, okay, so here we have two Johns. You spot a large man with a youthful gait. I don't know what the fuck gait means. Carrying a heavy crate over his shoulder with relative ease. Oh, you're Officer Shaw. He gives a bright, warming smile. Two Johns. That's what they call me. I'm sure you'll get your nickname later. Two Johns attempt to offer a handshake, but loses control of the crate. He struggles before firmly holding it in place with both hands. Maybe later. Work awaits.
What is this? Descend below deck. The forecastle appears to be locked. You can hear the kennel master preparing the room inside.
Right. So let's go down. Let's go below deck. Stride. Step equals gate. Right.
It's descend even more. Approach the cook.
It's here. You find yourself almost knocking over a man carrying a heavy pot. Careful! You almost got drenched in broth. Apologies, I'm in a rush on request for Hunt. You're the ship's cook, are you not?
Indeed I am. And I've got a full plate on my hands, pardon the pun. You hear a roar from the other side of the door.
Oi! What's holding you up?
The cook shakes his head with a smile and chuckles slightly to himself. He grabs the large pot and prepares to make his way to the hungry crew before turning his head to you. If you don't mind, could you carry that tray of biscuits behind me?
What the fuck? I'm the first mate and I'm carrying shit now?
No apologies given? For what?
Two Johns looks a bit hobo-like, just Akko's type.
Yep, there's going to be some cock-sucking here.
Grab the plate and follow the cook out the door and to the table where the crew are waiting with bated breath. Upon the cook's arrival, the sailors let out a rowdy cheer, the ship's cook placing the broth upon the table. Trust me, fellas, this one is worth the wait. The cook speaks with a tone of pride as he ladles the broth into the bowls of the crew.
Oi, one at a time, you animals.
Ward, you're awfully handsy for only one arm.
Ah, piss off, Junior.
Got some bread here too. Grab it fast before Tucker beats you to it. The crew laugh and are merry as Junior guides you back through the kitchen.
You're Junior?
I take that to mean Hunt told you about me. Sent you to fetch me, did he? Did he not give you a description? Or were you just not paying attention to the cook?
Is that how they spoke, or do you think that's a bug?
I think it's a grammar oopsie.
because it is, yeah, this does not seem, or were you just not paying attention to the cook? All right, I'll grab this one as well. I fucking hate the fact that it continuously craps on itself, but anyways. All right, here we go. You seem popular. We weren't properly introduced. Well, Hunt wished to see you as soon as possible. The reason I'm doing this, by the way, is because I know there's a vote later for me to become captain. Spoilers. So I'm being nice to everyone to get as many people to vote for me as possible. I want to see if there's a difference, because last night they did this and they won 10-9. I want to see if you can actually sort of influence the vote. Robin Shaw, right? I've been keeping track of all the new crew. Yaron Stokes, but nobody calls me that. You'll hear them all call me Junior. You should do the same. No idea why Hunt picked someone who's he's never worked with as first mate, but you seem the helpful sort. Glad to have you aboard. Have you been traveling with Hunt long? I am the people's choice, of course. Dude, if I ran for president, everyone would vote for me. First man overboard, voted off the ship, Sag. Dude, if that happens, I'll kill myself. My brother and I are among Hunt's most tenured crew. It's not often he'll hire outsiders, but I suppose his job is too big for just the usual suspects. He did give me his name. You seem popular. Well, you know what they say about the hand that feeds. Sides, half the crew I've known for years. You don't spend that much time on a ship with folk without learning all about them. Why Junior? Simple nickname. My older brother is in the crew. Hence, Junior. Not very interesting, I know, but it is what it is. Well, Junior, don't expect me to be a pair of hands whenever you need. I'm often busy. No, let's not be a dick. We need his vote. Ah, yes, good old Hunt. Never a rest on this ship, let me tell you. Especially when Hunt takes a liking to you. I guess, call the crew for dinner. Hey, here we go. Dinner time! It passes in relative silence. Wait, it's opposite, the hand that wipes? Fucking ew, bro. Signal Warden, thanks for the deal. What's up? I really appreciate that. 12 months in a row. Thank you. Dude, why would you have someone else wipe your ass? A crew returns to their post. The hammocks are unfold and in preparation for the evening. Twilight falls. Over dinner, you overhear the newly picked up stowaway speaking with a one-armed man. But da, your lucky Hunt didn't throw you overboard. Half a mind to do that myself. Come on, da. I'm here to help. Better know that involves work. Don't expect special treatment. I won't. You're an impossible child to me. Alright, Timmy's an impossible child. I thought the saying was, don't bite the hand that feeds you. Not according to Smolder. According to Smolder, the fucking saying is, don't bite the hand that wipes you. Probably because the hand is full of shit. And also, for some reason, Smoldering can't wipe his own ass. I just saw your video about forums, but I think Rita was talking about mounts like Guild Wars 2, on which mounts have something special per family. I can't remember exactly all the problems we had with Rita, but we had problems with Rita, Darkoon. You spot one of Templeton's science team pacing around the mid-deck, searching through some luggage that has been pulled from a cabin. Let me look in the light. Where was it now? He notices you. Ah, Officer Shaw, correct. Dwight Glossley. Apologies, I seem to have misplaced something while settling in the cabin. Bottle of wine, actually. Can't be Artemis. It will turn up eventually. I would hope so. My wife and I bought a bottle to celebrate with. To be saved for the journey back, of course. Well, if you find it, please let me know. If I find he's... Oh, shit. I have a cabin, too. I didn't even know. Let me see what my cabin looks like. Absolutely fuck all in there. Wow, that is, Jesus. The first mate gets like barely room. As you look over the railing out to the ocean, a wisp of smoke flies past your face. You turn to examine and spot a sailor with a pipe in his mouth and a sheet of paper in his hand, overlooking the stirring waters. Cask, thank you for the prime sub, dude. Really appreciate that. 41 months in a row, bro. That is fucking crazy. How you doing, brother? You turn to examine and spot a sailor with a mouth open and stirring paper, overlooking the stirring waters. Smoking sailor. Looking at something? How many sailors can read or write? What's the letter? A letter. All you need to know. Tashi. After introducing himself, Tashi falls silent and begins to read the letter. Trying to draw conversation from him may be similar to extracting teeth. I did get to meet him. You spot Templeton looking out into the sunset. As you approach, he turns to you and nods. Ah, Officer Shaw. It will be some time before we see a sunset such as this again. The light distribution towards the southern pole is quite the change. I notice you weren't at dinner with the others. It will be quite some time before we return home. You got a room with a bed and no roommate? That's luxury compared to the rest of the sailors? Yeah, but I'm the first mate, dude. Where's my seven virgins? Indeed. Keeps his focus on the reflection of the settling sun over the stirring waters of the ocean. There is great expectation upon us, officer. From who? Who is this benefactor of ours? That is not for you to know. Not yet. I think you're on the wrong cruise. Am I? Dude, I have seen cruises on Pornhub, and there's always virgins. I don't think this is historically accurate. Le Chateau, use the chamber pot. Greed, seven virgins at bare minimum. Absolutely. I don't think this is how it used to be. Templeton looks down, catching his reflection in the ocean surface. He looks back up at the sunset. Quite the sight. But I wouldn't linger upon it too long. We should retire for the evening. It's important the first officer be well rested. Use E to advance to the next week. Alright, here we go. Oof. We'll do one, and we'll do half. What happens if we do none? Oh, we'll lose quite a bit, actually. I think that should be fine for now, right? Let's go. 10 fuel, minus 25 food, minus 10 decorum. The ship makes it past the port of Whitetail. Cordell's sledding dogs are picked up. The scouting crew and Kurt Darlings are picked up. The days are getting brighter as you move further south. Start the next week. Because virgins can also be slutty. Who goes there? What are you hiding? what's that first resource? This is the quorum, clean. So this is, if there's zero, there will be a mutiny. And you'll be thrown overboard. The door swings open to reveal Kurt Darling, all but filling its frame, grinning ear to ear. Never said virgins would be chicks. Could be a bunch of male virgin hobos, for what we know. Possible. There you are, Officer Shaw. The ship's navigator is a difficult man to miss. Stature and reputation precede him. Adorned with a slew of apparatus, this seemingly one-man expedition would be known to anyone following the heyday of exploration and the merchandising that followed. It's an honor. We need to get his vote too, by the way. A wealth of invaluable experience in such hostile environments. A wonder he's not been swept up to some other post. Hiding away from the rest of us, are you? Do you need something off me, Kurt? No, I'm simply busy.
Of course. The role of first mate must surely take up a great deal of your time. Apologies for not stopping by sooner, Shaw. I've been busy myself. It took a while to set up my team, and a great deal of the crew were quite eager to meet me. It's not often they work with a film star, is it? That's right, you're something of a celebrity, aren't you? Certainly. It's completely understandable on their part. There aren't many who haven't seen my films, particularly in this line of work. More than one fellow on this crew said my work inspired them to explore the world. Quite the honor, is it not? I'm certain you receive their praise often. The crew don't seem the film-going type. Is there a point to any of this grandstanding? Not so often as you would think. I suppose I did get distracted, didn't I? Anyway, I was hoping you'd join me up deck. Does Hunt require my presence? No, no. We finally entered the pack. I thought you'd want to see it for yourself. I'll right behind you, so that's another bug. Sorry, guys. I'm just doing this because I know Balil and them would want to have these bugs reported. So are you ready for Diablo Immortal or 4? I don't know. Are we going to play Diablo Immortal? It can wait. I have work to do. We'll be moving through the ice for a while. I'm not interested. Is he talking to a bed? No, your character is just not on screen, Kazushin. Kurt turns to walk away before turning back. Oh, and enjoy your morning. It's a good day, Shaw. Arr. He leaves. All right, let's go. Oof, who the hell is this? Mrs. Gloss. You note one of the science team returning to their room. Ah, Mrs. Gloss. Did you have a good rest? She nods to you. Hello. I did not expect many to be up this early. Harriet Glossley. I believe I've met your husband. Ah, yes. Dwight made mention of your encounter. He's still fast asleep. He's adjusted to ship well. Wait, that was wrong. Fuck. I skipped that. I shouldn't have skipped that. That was completely wrong. Do you ever choose an appearance for your character, or are you just never seen? Your outfit in the log. So if you go to the log here, this outfit, your outfit there changes based on your decisions that you made in the beginning of the game. But as you can see, you don't have an appearance. So if you look here, your face is completely scratched out of the picture. You can see Captain Akko, you ever sail? Yeah, I sail all the time. I believed a walk around the ship would help acclimate myself to the waves. Oh, this is also wrong. There's quite a few spelling mistakes. I'm gonna have so many fucking screenshots to share with Balani's team. By the way, what was that WoW mobile game? Did it seem good? Avalanche, not really. Perhaps it will take some more time. With that, Mrs. Gloss makes her way back to her cabin. The science team aren't used to the sea, or the sailor folk. Quite the culture clash, isn't it? Well, I'm sure they'll grow used to them over time, Har. And this is the doctor's office. The door of the doctor's office remains locked. Seems the good doctor isn't in, or perhaps enjoying his sleep. You are yet to come across the ship's doctor, even after all this time. Dude, are we gonna find out that our doctor is fucking dead? Many of the crew are still fast asleep, laying in hammocks. Best not disturb them, Shaw. You don't want to find any yourself dealing with an abruptly woken sailor. Let us head up deck. And the snoring are rather obnoxious.
I would say it's similar to Clash of Clans, I guess.
At the stern, you notice an older sailor at the helm. The old man takes in a deep breath in the cold air before letting out a satisfied exhale. Morning. And a good morning to you. His eyes you up. Officer Shaw, right? Lefty. Call me that on account of, well, should be obvious. He chuckles. Don't worry about my bad sight. This is all feel. Just keeping her steady. He examines you. Surprised, handpicked from the outside for his first mate. I'm surprised as well. He seems the insular type. I assure you, I'm more than qualified for the role. Would you prefer the role? You seem to have the experience. Oh, I don't doubt that. You must be something special for Hunt to look outside the ranks. I am. I'm a soldier. I've won the war single-handedly. Hunt doesn't have much fondness for the military, but it at least means you've got the work ethic. Mornings like these are about the only peace I get from the younger lot. You should take these moments when you can. Lefty returns his attention to the helm. As you get older, I suppose you learn the value of the quiet moments, eh? Let us hope we're just as diligent when we're old and grey. Myself before you, of course. Of course. Alright, let's hear what's going wrong here. You join Kurt at the bow of the ship. You both feel the Temperance break the flows below you. Gripping the railing, he draws an enormous breath. The footing beneath rises, the ship mounts an impeding ice flow. There is a moment's hesitation before a profound crack relieves the ship, cascading across the ice. Yes, Agriel, this is Bellulars game. He exhales. See? Nothing else like it. You weren't wrong. I assumed you'd seen everything. It's just ice, Kurt. Don't get too excited. A younger me would have agreed with you. It's an interesting mix. Nostalgia and the never-ending new. Look at the ice. No two cracks are the same. All caused by us. Did you just want to show me the ice? I need a navigator, not a poet. By the laws of nature, this place wants us dead. And yet, here we are, traversing in harmony. How fantastic is that? How far are we from land? You weren't wrong, it's just ice, Kurt. We're about a week's sail from the last known location of the old Viscount. Assuming she isn't exactly where they left her, we can't take smooth sailing for granted. Evans, yeah, the game is pretty fucking relaxed, which is, I think, the point. It's all about the story and the decisions you make. It won't remain this bright for so long once winter encroaches. Beautiful as the ice is, on this course it's going to get thicker. It looks out across the white. We won't be so confident when the leads dry up and we're stuck here till the next cycle. We need to change course. Avoid the pack. Have you informed Captain Hunt? He won't listen to me. Thinks I've been dulled by retirement. I've probably seen more ice than he has whiskey. Decision-based games like this are so much fun. It really gets you thinking. True, it's very relaxed until frostbite sets in. Yeah, but luckily, we're not going to get frostbite. It's not my decision. Yes, but you have the captain's ear. Have you ever experienced the long night winter? It's not pleasant, to say the least. There's a chain of command. This isn't one of your adventure serials, Kurt. Can't say that I have. We're only as good as the unhappiest man, Robin. Cheer up, then. Kurt smiles. I'll do what I can. Thank you for bringing this to my attention. Just wondering, did Balila mention how long this game would be? Yes. I think they said 6 to 8 hours. 10 if you're, like, really trying to do everything. Jumbo, whose emote is that? Nods and turns back to look across the ice. Just look at this. Dude, it must be so peaceful in here. Huh? It must be so fucking peaceful. Just going through the motions.
Like, before we had technology and you were literally just, this ship was your entire world. All right, let's take requests. Ah, sure. Ready for another day of work? Did you hear Kurt's advice? He wants us to switch course. Aye. He had a few words to share. He may have been an expert in his time, but these days Kurt is one with more money than sense. Anyway, back to work. I was hoping you'd help me through a few more requests from the crew. You may have noticed the line pulling up outside. Everyone wants something, it seems. Call them in as you please. We are born too late for the great discoveries of Earth and too soon for the exploration of space. Well, not necessarily, Niara. Not necessarily. They're working tirelessly at eternal life or longer life. We could very easily, within the next decade, discover the cure to aging, which means we're born just right for space exploration. Should post dank memes, though. Pretty much, Tech Priest. Much of the sea has not been discovered yet. Yeah, but it's not the same kind of discovery. Now you're going into a submarine in order to discover much of the sea. Place unexplored yet, for example, depths of the ocean. A short, sour-faced man in engineering clothes approaches. Are you acting daft, Hunt? Not with intention. Not bloody surprised you didn't notice. Sure, this is our chief engineer, Clive Hammond. An opinionated one. What is it, Hammond? You've hit the ice, and you haven't assigned any extra men down on the boiler. You have your engineering team, and we're only got six arms between us. I need more manpower maintaining this. Sailors. Many of the crew have their own tasks they're busy with. I know I've already assigned Smurf on a matter. The day we find aliens hiding in bases at the deepest parts of the ocean, the conspiracy nuts will lose their shit. What do you think the chances are that we will discover aliens in the oceans? The captain turns to you. How many do you think is fair? One? Three? More! Open the crew manifest to choose how many sailors you wish to assign. Assign the crew. Alright, so this is max cards allowed 4, minimum cards required 1. It doesn't actually tell you what ice savvy would mean. This guy's locked. Fuck. Let's take this guy, Corvid. One for now would be fine, right? What do you guys think? One should be fine. Already did. Some of those fish in the depths sure look alien. I remember there was an island with only Aborigines. Someone trying to spread the great Lord Jesus Christ and he died there. Let's do 2, but that might be a bit too much. For now, at least. Fuck it, we'll do that now. You can take Corbett and Joe. You'll have to do with 2, I'm afraid. The engineer holds his tongue. Fine. But you can tell me how right I was when we're buried under the ice. Dude, I've given you 2 fucking people. A good spirit, that one, beneath the oil in the temper. You won't be seeing much of him, though. Prefers to borrow himself in the boiler room. Alright, Kasha. Captain Shaw. I thought occurred to me the other day. Alright, that's another bug that we have to fucking sort out. Not really bugs, it's more just grammatical and spelling mistakes. But still, you know. You gotta do our due diligence, just in case. Well, it might be too late for this now that we've already entered the ice. Out with it. I thought it would be good to have individual photos of the full crew. For your report. Not only my report, it would be good reference for the manifest. Put faces to the names. Much of this crew have served me for years, some decades.
I have little problem putting faces to the names. Your thoughts, Shaw. It seems a good idea. If nothing else, it would make for a good souvenir. A waste of time. We should be bracing ourselves for the ice, not posing for pictures. It's a bit late, but it's now or never. May as well get it over with. Aye, a good point. But maybe you could sound a little more infused. Well, Balfour, I see no problem there. I'll arrange for the pictures to be taken before the crew have their dinner. Thank you, Captain. In the meantime, I'll attempt to get as many individual crew photos as I can. You're still welcome to help on that matter, Officer Shaw. She departs satisfied. Corvid. Corvid enters the office. Hunt, you asked for a report on how the stowaway was doing. Aye. I wanted to see if the young boy has been settling in well. He has indeed. It means another mouth to feed, but the boy works hard and doesn't ask much. He has his Da to guide him as well. I'm sure the boy's father is ecstatic. Easily overlooked, especially if you've read it before. True, but this is why I'm just screenshotting it, and I'm just gonna send everything to Bellulars, and then, you know, they can work with it. Philomas wants one worker for the Republic of Mars. I am in, to be honest. Niara, you would actually go to Mars. I would not. The internet would be a fucking bitch. Like, hell no. Can you imagine your MS playing games from Mars? Fuck that. I already live in South Africa, and I'm well and truly upset with the 200 MS that I'm playing with. I am not for fuck gonna be playing games with what? The MS there is gonna be easily 4,000 or 5,000 MS? No, thank you. Worried sick, but happy I. Well, what do you know, Shaw? Perhaps we were right to keep the boy aboard. Yeah, you'd probably, I mean, what would the lag be to Mars, do you think? 20 minutes, half an hour, an hour worth of lag? Radio wave takes 20 minutes. So you could probably look at maybe a little bit faster than radio waves. Of course, all of this can be made easier if we dropped a bunch of satellites in between us and Mars, which could probably do it. Because moving at the speed of light, technically it should be very fast, right? But then again, maybe by that time we have quantum computing, so then there's no lag? Good to have all that settled then. Perhaps we shouldn't rule out old Kurt so easily. If the man thinks there could be an alternate path through the ice, he's free to search for it. Sure, meet him when you have the time. Changing course or not, we'll want one of his scouts set up in the crow's nest. Take care of that, then you'll be done for the day. JCB, but this is why I'm saying I think we need the ship. Your eyes notice a figure darting by, climbing on the ropes with ease. Figure lands on their feet before dusting themselves off. Their outfit denoted one of Kurt's scouting crew. Ah, no problems. She looks to you. And you are? Officer Shaw, yourself. Flick. I'm one of Kurt's crew. Don't worry about my safety. I know what I'm doing, trust me. Kurt doesn't just hire anyone. Well, he didn't hire me for no reason. Got the medals in gymnastics, if you're worried about my credentials. Flick jumps up and returns to scaling the rigging of the ship. Okay. What is this? Approach the sick young man. Seasick. You spot a youthful-looking man leaning over the... Does this guy look youthful to you? I mean, this guy looks about to fucking retire, if you ask me. So far, I am enjoying the game. I'm definitely enjoying the game. Radner, how you doing, bro? This guy looks as if he's about to retire. But anyways, you know. If we get... So, in order to actually play online games from Mars, nothing short of quantum internet and quantum computing can be done with it. Leaning over the side of the ship, his head slumped as he looks into the icy pool below. It appears he's been visited by a spot of seasickness. Pat him on the back.
Are you okay? Leave the man to his illness. You make your way to the man and reach out your arm to pat the sickly fellow on the back. As soon as your hand reaches him, he jolts upright in shock. A bespectacled young man, shaking with unease. He stares at you for a brief moment, a look of shame plastered upon his face. Sorry. Are you all right? I haven't seen you around. Who are you? Compose yourself, man. We should be able to handle the waves. Mars can have an independent internet, though. But you're going to be playing games with what? Like three other people? That's going to suck. What multiplayer games in Star Trek universe are like? I mean, don't they have quantum computing there? Are you all right? Yes? Well, not really. I'm very sorry. The man turns around and hurriedly runs in the opposite direction, avoiding your gaze. Arthur Nutley. All right. Send me up there. I'll get you a reading. Scientist eyes the man's cane and turns to you. I believe the navigator means you to send one of his scouts. The navigator clears his throat and taps his cane. Of course. If you find one of mine, they'll get us a reading, rightly. All right, we need to put Flick up here. There you go, Flick. Give us a reading. Denise and take a reading with the sextant. All clear from up top. Okay, so here is our map. Viscount Island. Last known location of the Viscount. Your destination. And this is Whale Tail Island. The last port you made where you picked up Kurt and the scouting team. Right. So how the fuck do I... How do I get out of this map? Hello? I guess I just need to end the week now. Just plug your RJ45 on your nearest wormhole on both sides. Easy. That'll be one lone cable to reach Mars. You definitely can't do it with cables. In a year for that signal to push through an update from Mars, to be honest? Not if you have quantum internet. Because with quantum entanglement, you could absolutely have internet instantly. If we could perfect quantum entanglement internet, it would be instant. I don't see the ship on the fucking map, do you? I don't think the ship is on the map. Yeah, I guess we just have to go to week two. Oh, here we go. We can return like that. Listen. Okay, let's listen. Hold up. You overhear two of the newly arrived scouting crew talking. Ah, Quilzy. Have any trouble settling in? Not too bad. I can't wait for a chance to sleep, though. A proper navigator never rests until their work is done. Of course. Not at all. The crew are a funny lot. Old Kurt certainly caught their attention. Or Ebb, how you doing, brother? It only takes 20 minutes for radio signal to reach Mars. Yeah, but you can't play games with a 20-minute delay. What's that going to feel like? Or, do you think any of them would mistake Kurt and myself? I think you'd collapse from joy if they did. Or perhaps. Right, so we've made two of the crew. Let's go downstairs. Let's hear what this guy has to say. Approach this guy. He spots you and seizes his plane. Need something? You're Grimly, aren't you? The man grunts. I? Grimly Stoke. It's the ship. I'm the ship's carpenter. Nice accordion. Do you mind if I see? Ah, then you're Junior's brother. If you're the carpenter, shouldn't you be working? Junior? Oh, you're sure. Junior mentioned you. In a positive or negative light, are we going to be needy or just not even give a fuck? I was just speaking to him too. And it was good to meet you, Grimly. I'm sure he talked your ear off. Won't keep you from your work. Don't keep me from my break. The hell? Alright, let's see. Hey, Shaw, can you grab some tins from the pantry? It's nearly time for dinner. To the pantry. Grab some tins. Get out. Give him the fucking tins. What will it be today, Shaw? Feed the hoshbot. That's pretty much all I have at the moment. Leave? Hooded sailor. You spot a suspicious looking... Just Joran! Thanks for the follow, dude. Really appreciate that. Welcome to the channel. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You spot a suspicious looking sailor emerge from the pantry. The hooded sailor spots you, keeping their hands firmly in their pockets. Not what it looks like, Officer Shore. Plek, but call me gnomes. I'm not thieving anything. I will take you at your word. I hadn't considered that, but now... You best have a good explanation, then. I have a perfectly good explanation. No worries, I was just setting up a practical joke. Well, best of luck with that. And what is this practical joke? Nothing going to spoil the not going to spoil the surprise. It's not at your expense, if that's your concern. Have to get some enjoyment around here, don't you think? With their mysterious trap set, Gnome scurries off to the upper deck to return to work. What do you think they're, It's dropping no Eve, sir. Let's call the crew for dinner. Arr! Shall we toast to the ice? Aye. The days get longer, but dinner is fixed. It will see us through the long days and the darkest nights. The crew return to their posts. The hammocks are unfolded in preparation for the evening. You can't help but notice that it's still bright light outside. Listen, you notice two sailors passing by from the dinner table. An inebriated sailor on wobbling legs, leaning on the shoulder of another. Ah, good times, good times. No need to learn to handle your drink, Tucker. Ah, but I'm fine. My mates can carry me, Cavity. They can also drop you. Have two Johns carry you next time. Tucker, drunk as fuck. Are you asleep? Shit. Right, so how many crew members could we still need to meet here? The hell is behind? You knock on the door. No response. Okay. Do we miss anything here? No one else to really talk to here. All right. Gobert is wearing a mask. Coincidence? I don't know. Maybe. Here we go. Listen to these two. You overhear two engineers chatting above deck. Or rather, you overhear one engineer speaking with another. Don't know how the chief could stay down there all evening. You ever see Mr. Hammond eat? I haven't. Maybe he doesn't even eat. Man's not human if he can work all day and night on that boiler. Probably doesn't sleep either. He probably sleeps. Aye, Dick, it's figurative. Right. A little bit of gentle fucking comedy there, but all right. Approach the dogs. The dogs regard her with rapt attention as she paces between them, bowl in hand. The largest joins her, Zach Flamo. Thanks for the first time chat, dude. Really appreciate it. Welcome to the channel. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Hey, bro. Have you ever tried playing Warhammer Online? It's got really deep lore and the RER PvP is amazing. Zach Flamo, no, I haven't. I do not give a shit about the PvP, though. But I did say that I will play it at some point to see the story. Because I do like the Warhammer lore, so I might give it a go just to see the story. Drink all the time. The largess joins her side as you approach. Try some. Try the soup. Is she gonna make us eat fucking dog food here? You nearly burn your mouth in the hot broth. It's disgusting. Surprisingly tasty. Spit it out. I don't know what it tastes like, but okay. Surprisingly tasty. It's surprisingly palatable. You feel yourself warming up. You seem to enjoy it. I'm afraid there is only so much. If you want more, it will be among the dog's leftovers. Penguin, some blubber, fats and proteins. Fastest way to hydrate them. Was there something you needed? Just inspecting the animals. Just inspecting the animals. They belong here more than we do. Unlike us, they need the ice. It cools them through their paws as they run. They'd overheat otherwise. You've been on the ice for a long time? Can't sex her, Euro. But why would you want to sex her? She's not the hottest here. A long time, yes. Strong creatures, who's that beside you? This is Stanberry. Bark. Strong animal. Very. They handle stress differently. Adapt quickly. There's plenty to be learned from them. You love these animals. That's the thing. PvP is the meta, which is sad. I'm currently leveling a warrior priest, as they are great at solo content. I'd love to do some public quests, etc. with you. Well, I actually stole a lot of Warhammer Online ideas. Like I said, I just wouldn't really partake in the PvP, but I would be interested in playing it just to see what it's like. You know nothing, Shoako? Bro, I'm the first mate. You will speak with me. You will speak to me with some level of fucking respect. I'm the first mate, bitch. What are you gonna do? I will throw you under the fucking ice. You know, Akko, she might like a doggy style. Don't most people like a doggy style, though? They need me. And you'll need them. Pet Stanberry. You ruffle its head, tries to lick the broth from your fingers. Right. We've met the dogs. I'm guessing that's pretty much it. It doesn't seem like there's any other way. Nothing else for us to do, just sort of... here we go. Next day. Water is cold, better not bath now. We could still be on 1 year, and we could probably still only have half of our fuel rations. Should be fine. Let's go. The day grows even brighter. Start the next week. So far, I'm really enjoying the story here. So far, I'm enjoying it. All right, here we go. Is there anyone that we can talk to here? No. Fuck. All right, we are now in the thick of things, people. Look at this. It's ice as far as the fucking eyes can see. Captain's cabin, take requests. Captain Hunt appears to be absent. His chair is unoccupied. Best get started now. Fuck. Okay. Examine the problem. What in the... Well, I was worried about this. Look at that ice. We could be trapped for a while. Strong pressures. As if we didn't have enough bother. Well, no need mucking around. Let's get to work. Where's Hunt? I'll grab him. I'm sure he felt it too. Sure, check the boiler room. I'm sure the mole man has problems of his own. Not to worry, everyone. We'll be free and moving again before you know it. Back to work. The hell's the boiling room? Let's talk to Kasha. After you're sure, what happened? Ship's come to a stop. I almost flung my camera into the wall. We didn't hit anything, did we? Have you seen Hunt? We're trapped in some ice. We'll need to break loose to get moving again. Stay where you are. I don't want you doing anything reckless for a photograph again. Well, the playable races, the BL would have. Also, wow, I have a question for you. Can you imagine if Microsoft made it to where the Horde and Lions formed together and they made the Burning Legion a playable faction? I mean, it would be interesting for a small while, but I don't think it would be, like, I don't think that it would be workable in the long term.
Well, let's hope we can do that sooner rather than later. Trapped in the ice, though, that would make a good photograph.
Then go take a fucking photograph of it. I'm not sure what I'm doing, but I'm supposed to be doing, like, going in there. Pumps. Okay. There's pumps. Here's the pantry. Let's take ourselves a bit of canned food. Just in case we need to feed the broth, you know? Descend to the lower decks. Who the hell is this? Grimly. Ship stuck then. If you're looking for Hunt, you just missed him.
How? We didn't cross paths.
Don't ask me. I'm going to check with my brother. Alright. Alright, here we go. Approach the two men.
Aye. If I'd made errors any, I tell you. It's secured. Don't you worry.
They notice you. Impressive machine, this boiler.
Aye, she'll keep us steady, no doubt. Be grateful we have it.
I'm ensuring that the boiler was not damaged in the sudden commotion.
And I told you that if it was, you'd already know. I'm not in the business of making mistakes. I know that if the furnace goes, we go down with it.
Yes, but you're only one man. With just a pair of engineers' assistants.
Just looking at the number of valves, this seems far too much for you to handle.
Maybe your bloody benefactor should have considered that.
I've gotten used to it by now. It'll hold, trust me.
I will. Well, I will have to, won't I?
It's very loud. Fuck.
The music fluctuates quite a bit in this game, from being not too loud to being stupidly loud.
The introduced Foul Orc as a playable race, that would be cool as fuck.
Well, what would be the difference between Foul Orc and Magar Orc? Because eventually you're going to end up with the same problem as elves, just too much of all those things at the same time. Wouldn't boats headed for ice have metal plating on the front to cut the ice better? I think they do, but the ice here is stupidly thick at the minute, Blue Fairy.
I don't fancy staying on the ship any longer than necessary. It's imperative we break free from the ice as quick as possible.
Emmett eyes you, a grimace on his face. First mate here, but where's the one who got us into this bloody mess?
He's a difficult one to find. I was hoping that Templeton knew.
He may be in his cabin, I'm not sure.
Does the music increase to clue you into the fact that something's wrong or about to go wrong?
I'm not sure. I haven't really paid attention to it that much yet.
Indeed he is. I have a suspicion as to where he may be now. We're on a ship, an unmoving one at that. The man cannot simply disappear. If he's anywhere, he must be in his cabin. When you find the man, give him an earful on my behalf. Can't do it myself, too busy keeping us alive.
I believe you and I both owe our good captain a visit, Shaw.
Not before we fit this furnace. Mind grabbing some coal from the bunker, Shaw? Or are you afraid of dirty hands like Mr. Templeton over here?
Yeah, I don't mind.
Let's grab some coal. Bam.
Now we can leave, get in here, into here. The coal goes in, we stay alive. Really, that simple. Confirm.
Alright, you emerge mid-deck to find the crew readying themselves for dinner.
Feed the hoshbot.
Do we need more food?
Alright, yeah, that's fine, I guess.
25 food, leave.
Oh, fuck me. It doesn't give me the freedom to basically go wherever I want right now. So I have to do this first.
Crew have their meal. The dinner is shared.
The hammocks are unfolded in preparation for the evening. You can't help but notice that it's still bright light outside. Let's listen to this. You didn't see him either? He didn't pass by, but his cabin door was locked when I checked. Slippery bastard. What are you thinking, Hunt? Right, so they don't know where he is either. That's not great. No sign of Hunt, I take it? Mr. Templeton passed by, but he wasn't exactly willing to take questions. Dude, where's the fucking captain? Keep it up, lads. We'll set ourselves right in no time. Ah, sure. I just saw Templeton entering the captain's cabin. Seems Hunt's holed himself up inside. Maybe if you had a word with our good captain, he'd be willing to lend a hand. Speak to Templeton. Look at the fucking captain there. Knew the damn voyage was cast? I was informed that he was here. Where could he have hidden himself? Maybe he's gone overboard. He has to be in here. Check under his desk. At this point, leave the man. I will handle matters. Despite Hunt's issues, there is still a chain of command. We cannot waive it so flippantly. Har! The captain's laugh rings out from behind the door. The captain watches you both, his head swaying as he chuckles to himself. You are a surprisingly difficult man to get a hold of, Hunt. Seeing that this is your ship, I know it well. Hunt's eyes turn to you. I believe you two are already acquainted. How long have you been drinking? I don't suppose you get to join. Hunt shakes the whiskey bottle as you hold it out, the liquid sloshing and spilling from the top. And what of you, Shaw? I can't tempt you with some sweet nectar. I don't drink. And you don't care to humor me this once? Ah, well, your loss. You intend to offer drinks at a time like this? The ship, your ship, is trapped in the ice. Gotta hop off for a meeting. Have fun, everyone. Blue Fairy, take care of yourself. Thanks for hanging out. Really appreciate it. It's my ship now, is it? And what do you expect me to do? Get the shovels out? You could have heeded Kurt's warning. What do you mean this isn't your ship? You could at least do your work. I've carried your load until now. Bought at an auction. Not by myself. Imagine that. Captain of a private vessel. And I don't even own it. Pathetic. Mr. Hunt, Captain. If you are not fit to stand, then you should retire for the night. Shaw will stand in your stead, and we can continue this in the morning. And abandon my duty? No captain who would do that is a fit captain. Would you agree? Well, not you. Shaw, isn't that right? What do you think makes for a good leader? Sobriety for a start. Making the difficult choices. Choices nobody else wants to make. Being able to do the job. Job I've been doing on your behalf. Do you think you could live with yourself? They all act like the choice is the difficult part. The choice is easy, sure. Instinctual. It's not being able to sleep after. That's what they never prepare you for. But I'm serious, sure. To you, what makes a good leader? We don't have time for... In a word, then. What makes a leader? What makes a leader, chat? If you were in my shoes now, would it be understanding, control, willpower? I see only one man thinks like I do. Two people, three people think like I do. Will of control? On a boat like this? In a time like this? Control? Explain. Control over your surroundings, your crew, to place them on the correct course. It's all appearances. They need a leader. You need to convince them you're worth following. Control over your emotions, to be able to remain calm, no matter the circumstances. I like the first one.
You need all three to some degree? Big talk, but do you really think that's possible? People aren't pieces on the chessboard. They think, they feel. They can move any direction they please. And all a captain has in common with the king is that you're both targets. Speaking in platitudes will do you no good. A good leader is something more than a single rule you were told to follow. When you see one, you just know. You've wasted enough time pining philosophical. Oh, my apologies. I'll ask the real questions. Sure, look at where we are. Do you honestly think we're going to survive this? I have no doubt we will. I've had assumptions on returning alive. You can't control what you don't understand. Dude, I understand this ship like the back of my fucking hand. The drunk one. Yeah, he's being very philosophical for a man that's drunk as a skunk. But I'm going to be optimistic and say yes, we'll live. I have no doubt we will. Well, I suppose someone has to carry faith with him. The captain laughs. Sure. Nobody knows we're out here. That doesn't leave this room. No, no. Wouldn't want to upset your employer. Our benefactor. We all want to be paid after this, don't we? Enough! If you weren't fit to lead this expedition, you should not have agreed to it. You shouldn't be. None of us should be here. Old Kurt paid handsomely to join. You're just a botanist saying to keep an eye on me, our doctor. And then there's me. And myself? What are we actually searching for? Time to get some answers. Hunt chuckles, gesticulating his hands mockingly. Ghosts. Templeton opens the door. The captain needs his rest. We'll discuss this once he's of sound mind. Let him speak, Templeton. I wish to know more. It's all right, Robin. Go on now, Shaw. I'll be all right here. Fuck. So, I'm assuming we're... Captain Hunt needs his sleep. It would appear the pressures of command have greatly affected him. You should find some rest yourself. The crew have their commands. Clear your head, and we will continue this on the morn. Oh, wait. The game is already released. This is the demo, Drayan. So, we're going... You awake to a room awash with green. There is a loud banging on your door, and a familiar voice speaks from behind the wood. Shaw, are you in there? Hammond, what's going on? Why is everything green? Are we sinking? What was that noise? Hammond, what is going on? Why is everything green? Never mind the green. The boiler's in serious trouble. Pumps need manned, and we need to stop the whole system overheating. And I don't need to tell you. I don't need to tell you. The furnace goes, we go. Lead the way then, we don't have a moment to spare. Right, let's move. We need to find the captain now. I mean, finding the captain, why? Kira rushes up, holding her camera tight as the ship rumbles. What's happening? Oh, are we going under? Not if we can help it. Out of the way. It's safe to go up top, right? The Aurora. It's a shot I can't miss. Before snapping a photograph of the ensuing chaos. Alright, what does this look like now? This looks quite nice, actually. But fuck, we're snowed in. How do you get through this? Like, we are basically now one with the glacier. Like, we and the ice have become one. How do you get through this? Nothing. Visibly perturbed, he takes a moment to compose himself. Even the tub is empty. Why would you expect him to be in the tub? Not important. This doesn't make sense. The man seemed barely fit to crawl himself into bed earlier. What? Hammond turns to you. All right, Shaw. Captain's missing. You're in charge. Good to hear. We can't give up on Hunt that easily. Yeah, I'm in charge. There we go. But don't you need a momentum to hit the ice ahead to break it? I wouldn't know. I'm just doing whatever the fuck they tell me. No hunting the ghosts. You are the ghosts. Don't get a big head about it. Yes, indeed. The crew are no doubt waking at this moment. They're no doubt scared, confused. It's your duty to keep them calm, to maintain order. Hammond glares at Templeton. It's Shaw's job to get down to the boiler room now. We've already wasted enough time looking for that bastard hunt. If you storm down to that room, all you'll be doing is inciting a panic. We need to calm the fears of the crew, maintain an air of focus. Lie to them as the ship goes down? Not at all. Instead, to assure them that we know how to remedy this matter. You do know how to remedy this matter, Mr. Hammond.
Aye. And we need to be quick. I don't have time to worry about some stupid sailor's feelings. We've got a bloody ship to save.
Well, it's as you said. Officer Shaw is in charge. The decision is yours.
What do you guys think? Do we walk around acting as if we know what the fuck we're doing, even though we know that the ship is about to go down? Or do we run like crazy, hysterical, into the boiler room to fix it?
I agree with Hammond as well, yeah.
So let's run like little bitches towards the boiler room, shall we?
Off we go. Hammond is right. We can't waste more time here. The boiler won't wait for us.
Fine. I will keep the crew at bay then.
Come on. Don't worry about him. Let's go.
Alright, there's no one to talk to here. As more of the crew notice you and Hammond ascending below, the whispers begin. Soon the crew pick up the pace, walking directionless with hurried footsteps. Kurt approaches.
Boiler trouble, I take it?
I'll lend a hand. Not when you're walking with a cane, you're not.
I have enough strength to...
Go tell the crew to hit the lower decks, as many as possible. Let's go, Shaw. Time to save this blasted ship.
And we've lost the quorum. Fuck! They're gonna mutiny.
Ahead, you can see the brothers trying to open the door to the hold.
Where are you two heading?
Boiler. It's the only thing that matters. We need to keep the furnace alight. Can you help us?
Going down there to kiss Whisper Whisper? These are brothers, Smolder. What the fuck kind of game are you playing?
The metal door unsticks. Grimly looks at you before darting off into the dark.
Where's that bloody idiot running off to?
To sound the alarm.
Bloody hells. Let's get moving.
You enter the boiler room. As you enter, Hammond's engineering team are hard at work. The larger of the two engineers loses grip of their valve as steam begins to shoot out, causing Hammond to dash forward.
Watch it!
Hammond tackles the engineer to the ground, saving him from a nasty steam burn. Made it just in time.
What's the word, Chief?
Keep those valves pumping. We need to avoid a water hammer, or we won't be making it off this ship.
Sure.
The rest of the crew aren't here. Grab a valve and start turning.
Fuck.
You grab a valve and begin turning, trying all you can to keep the water at bay.
Pump!
You feel the ache in your muscles as you continue to push the valve, keeping the pressures at bay. The furnace rumbles and sputters, hemorrhaging fuel. You keep turning, doing the best you can to keep the pressures at bay. We could be at this for hours.
Shit! Where's the rest of the crew?
Brought help!
The furnace rumbles and sputters. Give me coal and turn those valves!
Alright, so I have to grab coal. Let's grab some more coal. Wait, we can actually... Oh, I forgot. We can actually put people in here. Some sailors. Let's see. Do we want to put the smoker inside the coal room? Maybe not a good idea.
Let's put him in there as well. Fuck it. There we go.
They get to work. Good job, boys. Okay, here we go. Let's
put some fuel in this bitch. There we go. That's 100 fuel. Confirm. Valve.
Okay, sailors. We need sailors for this. Gnomes? Plague? Fuck me.
Let's put gnomes on this. Go.
They grab the valve. Now let's put... Runstar.
No, he's got one arm. That's not gonna work.
They grab the valve. With enough hands working on the boiler, you begin to fight back the potential water hammer.
What is a water hammer? Does anyone know? What's wrong with a little sibling intimacy? Shake my head.
Dude.
You guys are weird. Alabama intensifies.
Someone's going to have to hold the furnace in place.
Alright, who are we willing to lose?
Stun if it hits you. Bad news aboard a ship. Of course.
Let's do cavity. Fuck it.
They approach the furnace. Okay. Screenshot this as well. That's wrong.
Water hammer is the result of a pressure surge or high-pressure shockwave that propagates through a piping system when a fluid in motion is forced to change direction or stop abruptly.
Right, that doesn't sound good. Oh, here we go. Fuck.
Bad things are about to happen.
Water hammer!
Steam burned.
A jet of steam paints June. It subsides as they writhe in agony. You keep up the work, shifting the valves until the boiler has fully calmed. The ship is saved, you won't be sinking today. As the crew gives assistance to the wounded June, you feel your muscles tense. You fall back, collapsing from exhaustion. As you lay back, all you can hear are a pair of panicked voices.
Oh, crap.
The Temperance is saved from sinking. The Aurora passes, leaving only the bright light and white.
All right, chat.
We're moving ahead. Week 4. I think the demo goes up to week 8.
You are alone in the captain's cabin. Out across deck can be heard the commotion of the crew. Word has spread quickly that Captain Hunt is missing. Templeton slips through the door.
Sure.
What is it, Templeton?
Rufus Hunt is missing.
Hunt is still missing. And he isn't alone in that regard.
Fuck!
Sanders, Sparrow, and Grain are also unaccounted for.
What is happening to our crew?
As is a sizable food and fuel supply, and one of the larger lifeboats.
They've taken the fucking lifeboat.
Sure, you and I are not naive. It seems quite clear what has happened.
Yes, but why would Hunt abandon us?
This is a question I cannot answer. I doubt we'll ever know at this stage. The former captain is no longer with us. You understand what that means, sure?
I would care for you to enlighten me.
That would be Captain Shaw now, I take it.
Not quite yet. A new captain must be selected by the crew. Is that really how it works?
Isn't the first mate automatically main captain?
Can punch through the bulkhead?
As first mate, you have the most clear argument to take that role.
I don't know if I'm prepared. I would have expected the role to be inherited.
Not quite. They will hold a vote as soon as possible. Carpenter, Grimley. He is still loyal to Hunt, and many of the sailors
will follow his vote, if not all. Though I can assure you have the vote of myself and my scientists. Kurt and his crew are likely to support you as well. I am unsure where the engineers will side. They're likely loyal to their pay. Joom is still recovering from their steam burns, which may end up working to our favor. And the civilians are a mystery. But I believe when all is said and done, you will just about make the vote. You have clearly given this a lot of thought. Just about. My only competition could be dead for all we know. That's why have a chain of command to take over fast and keep going and not spend days voting. Well, you know, we are voting now. Loyalty runs deep among this lot. They're waiting outside, Shaw. They're scared. They don't know where to turn. You and I both understand the importance of maintaining decorum. Though times seem dire, remember, there is a rescue ship on its way. Even if the Temperance falls, we still have a potential escape. He's lying! The captain said no one fucking knows we're here, right? 42 weeks. The ship will arrive at Viscount Island in 42 weeks. We should focus on surviving that long. This is all we need to do, Captain. How can we be certain the rescue ship will come? The relief could become trapped just as we have. I understand. Interim leader until a new captain is elected. Most often it was the first mate that would be elected, but other times there would be a mutiny and essentially civil war on the ship. Fuck. In the military ship, yes, but your first mate is only in charge until he or someone else is elected. Well, I am a military man, so could I not just turn the ship into a military vessel? I can assure it. Our benefactor will ensure it. 42 weeks, Captain. Keep it in mind. Here, you should have this. Templeton presents you with a fancy-looking hat. Hunt's hat. He left it behind in his cabin. That tells us what we need, doesn't it? I won't be needing that. What about you? Do you wish to be captain? Yeah, give me the fucking hat. I choose to willfully observe reality. I suggest you do the same, Captain. The scientist refrains for a moment. Wait for him to continue. Out with it, Templeton. He's a criminal. Ain't no military about you, boy. Dude, that's not what they think. They think I'm an honorable soldier. They don't have to know that I'm not. I think it's best we declare that the captain and the missing crew are dead. There's no need for us to complicate things any further. I won't lie to them, Templeton. Leaders lie. Get used to it. The crew are waiting for you on the deck. Are we gonna lie to them or not? Hunt's ledger is gone. The last place you saw Captain Hunt, there's still drops of whiskey frozen. Okay, here we go. Oh shit, look at this crew, they're not happy. The hushed voices become more distinct as you make your way back out into the open air. You notice the absence of June. The crew members notice you and stop. Their attention ripples across the deck. Attention! It should be clear by now that Captain Hunt is no longer serving his post. As such, we should vote in the new captain. I nominate Officer Shaw for the role. The clear choice as first mate. And what of Hunt? I do not see him among us, do you? Don't see a body either. He's still out there. We don't know what happened. Something we can discover. For now, someone has to take the reins of command. All in favor of Shaw? Start. I don't even get to say shit. Alright, let's see. Joom abstained. He's a steam burn thing. Templeton and the scientists voted for me. Loyalty, I like it. Fuck. Wow, bastards. Abstain, loyal to Cordell. Loyal to you. Okay, I don't know if you can actually affect this. I don't know if you can affect this vote. captain. You have been confirmed as captain of the expedition. Well, the eyes have it. Shaw shall be acting captain from this point forward. Acting in Captain Hunt's stead. The crowd look to you expectantly as Templeton gives you a knowing nod. A moment passes in the cold as they await your next words. Curious murmurings scattering between the crew. Captain Hunt is no longer with us. To those who don't know me, I'm Robin Shaw. Wait for them to queen down. As they look to you, it's not long before the obvious question spills from the crew member's mouth. Where is Captain Hunt? Captain Hunt abandoned us. You notice Templeton's eyes widen. Whispers begin to roll throughout the crowd. He appears to have left this expedition along with three missing crew and one of our lifeboats. Ooh, this could cause chaos. I don't think we should be that honest. We're gonna fucking lose all our decorum right here, but okay. He appears to have left us, okay? The silence hangs in the air. I know you're all scared. As long as we keep our wits, there's no reason we can't survive this. I know you're all scared. To be honest, I'm scared too. You'd be a fool not to be. The crowd begins to bubble up once more, with more and more questions coming to the surface. Members of the crew start speaking out one by one, with question thrown your way in quick succession. How are we supposed to survive out here? Is help coming? What about our pay? Will we still be paid? I've said my piece on this. Get on with your work. We'll have to rely on each other out here. None of us expected this. We can't afford to stand at each other's throats. Best. Divided we are weak, but together we are strong. We can save that until we're out of this bloody ice. If we continue to squabble, we'll kill each other before the cold can get the chance. I know this isn't what we signed up for. Ask for reports, you know where to find me. Stick with me and I'll see us through. What of the lost captain? What of those lost, Captain? A memorial service will be held once the ship is freed from the ice. Those lost are no longer here, for now we must worry about ourselves. I think we'll have one as soon as we get to land, right? Echo gave you a shout out about his live stream on YouTube. Deish, how you doing, bro? Thank you. I appreciate that. A memorial service will be held once we make land. Understood. Well, you heard the captain. Get to it. Wait, Deish, what do you mean? You gave me a shout-out? Bal gave me a shout-out? How? Yeah, we obviously need more degens, right? Went through the beta and or whatever it was, and I'm hooked. Coming in demo. This isn't the beta. This is the demo. I miss the days when demos was a thing. Like, do you guys remember when every game would have a fucking demo? Why do more games not have demos? You're streaming his game right now? Deish, I really appreciate that. Thank you very much for that. It's a good game. Give you a shout out. Nice. Nice. Deish, thank you very much. Really appreciate it. Demos are such an indie old thing. Yeah, but demos work. Remember when PS1 had demo disc? I remember when a lot of games had demo disc. Alpen, how you doing? I love the demos on DVDs with gaming magazines. You pass Templeton. He glares at you. I told you. I won't lie to them. If we can't be honest with each other, what chance do we have? I hope you're right. All right, people, we're in trouble, by the way. Shaw, or should I say Captain Shaw, that Hunt, he didn't seem the type to just leave his crew behind. Still, no good dwelling. I have confidence you'll take up the mantle well. Do you have any experience leading expeditions? The crew are counting on me. I don't intend to disappoint. That's me. That's the spirit. Demos mean potentially less money because people will get to test it before they trick people into buying their games outright to test, or at least my guess from the AAA side. Direwolf, thank you very much for the follow. Really appreciate that. Welcome to the channel. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I personally think demos would almost always mean more money. If your game is good, if you actually believe in your game, a demo will almost always mean more money. If the captain has faith, so too will the crew. All right, let's take requests. Adrian, what do you mean? You saw the duties of the captain firsthand while serving Hunt. You're acting captain now. It's time. Let me just grab a screenshot of this. Man, this is going to be quite a few screenshots that I have to send, but okay. A line is already forming at the door. No surprise, given the circumstances. Take them as you may, Captain. Alright, that's it. Let's get Curtin Cordell. Captain, I've brought the Kennel Master with me. This is something you will both want to hear. I have a strong suspicion on what this matter is. I was planning to speak with the Captain on it myself. Fortunate happenstance, then. Captain, I know these conditions well. I've seen them before. Any idea of the Temperance being freed of the ice anytime soon is a pipe dream. We need to press on. We need to become aware of our new environment. Trust me, Captain. We will be living off it for quite some time. Oddly pessimistic of you, Kurt. And what of you, Cordell? Do you agree? Indeed. The dog sleds will need to be exercised regularly, and there is no better way than to engage in hunting. We're quite lucky, despite the circumstances. Now is the peak time for hunting and navigation. And navigation? Traversing the ice may be a possibility in the future. We need to prepare for that. If we're to survive out here, we need to know what lies ahead. These are uncharted territories, Captain. We have no idea where we are. Your current rations are not set to last forever either. Send any hunting party to me as you please. My dogs and I will ensure their survival. Cordell exits. The same sentiment for myself and any scouting teams. If you wish the great unknowns to be braved and charted, I'm your man. We need to know what lies ahead. Keep looking forward. All right, Hammond. Saving that boiler was only the start of our troubles. Have you seen the state of this bloody ship? It has certainly seen better days. We need to stockpile as much fuel as we can. If the furnace runs out by the end of the week, we die. If we spend too long on the ship, we die. If we don't stockpile enough fuel for the winter, we die. Aye. Get me some coal. Get it in the furnace. I'm afraid he's not wrong. That coal bunker is our only source of fuel for the time being, until we can procure alternatives. We should assign crew to shoveling whenever possible. Junior, sure. The ice looks unbudging, doesn't it? It would seem that way, yes. Crew seems to think so. They think if we don't intervene, the Temperance will never get freed. If you're suggesting breaking the ice, I can assure you that won't work. I'm not. They are. No intervention is going to break up the ice enough to free this ship. Putting others to work on that is simply a waste of manpower. Aye, maybe. Theos Gaming, how you doing, brother? They're scared, though. Worried. They just want to feel like they tried something. If it will raise spirits, it's worth the attempt. Let's do it. We need to raise the fucking attempt here. We'll do gnomes. Fuck it. Oh, we have to do three. Shit. Well, fuck. Alright, we're not gonna have many other people to do this. But can we do less than three? No, we have to do three. Oh, shit. Alright. We at least got some decorum.
Agreed. I'll see you for dinner, Captain. Don't forget the hotspot needs fed. Finish requests.
Before dinner, you should see to sending out your first sledding team. I also believe it's time you gave our good doctor a visit.
We'll still have wounded from the night of the Aurora. Their wounds will need attended before they're fit to work. And I doubt I need remind you of this, but we need every hand available. Don't be afraid of assigning my team for some manual labor. They'll complain, but they'll work.
It's over, listen here. You did seem familiar. I finally placed you.
You have? Have you?
Yes. I remember seeing you compete. Soren Killiper. You were quite the gymnast. I'm surprised to see you in this line of work. Not too many gymnasts carry long careers. You did quite well when I saw you at the Summer Games, I recall you placed. I don't recall winning.
Well, alright. She's not good enough. It's not good enough that she placed. She didn't win.
Well, good year. Friday evening, so that means Battle Alive. How is this demo coming along?
Fucking amazing, Theos Gaming. Such a cool game.
Yoshi specialists and others, not just sailors.
Yeah, but I wasn't sure if you can actually put specialists into those roles as well.
I can't believe Hunter's gone. What happened?
Who knows? He was drunk. Whatever he was thinking, he definitely wasn't in his right mind.
And what about Smarth and Corvid and Joe?
Who knows? Corvid owes me 5 gilts.
I don't think you'll be seeing it soon. Well, you might. You might.
All right, let's send out scouts.
Scout east, scout south, west, and north.
Go east.
The destination is marked for the sledding team. Maybe we'll go north as well?
We have no more dogs left, so this is it for us. Return.
What the hell? Grips.
Robin Shaw. Recognize that name somewhere? Royal Admiralty, right?
Heard of me? Am I supposed to know who you are?
Yes, I have. I think we served on some of the same ships.
We're building bases here? I don't know if there's base building.
So, I can't answer that yet. We're not there yet. If there is, we're not there yet.
All I can say is, it's much more grounded and tunnel than that.
You probably wouldn't have seen me, though. Didn't get much time out of the engineering room. Good to know the new captain has some experience.
Alright, let's go talk to the doctor.
Oh, shit. So, we've already met the doctor. That's nice.
You enter the ship's infirmary. Your presence seems to startle the young man inside, the rattle of dropped forceps ringing through the room.
Oh, goodness, it's you! Captain, now, isn't it?
You're the doctor, I take it.
Oh, right, yes, I am. Dr. Arthur Nutley, that's it.
It's good to meet you, Arthur. Are you having a spot of bother, Nutley?
Collect your thoughts. It's no good having a physician who cannot compose himself.
Nutley gives a weak smile.
Thank you. It is good to properly meet you. I suppose I seem a little scatterbrained at the moment. It isn't the norm. Recent circumstances have been trying. And the inclination towards seasickness is no help.
June. The steam burns they suffered from the furnace are severe. If you let me take a look, I can do my best to alleviate their pain.
Is there nothing more you can do?
I wish there was,
but there's no cure for these kinds of injuries. I'm afraid this is the extent. At this point, all we can do is wait. Nutley lets out a nervous cough. Captain Hunt, Do you think he may still be out there?
There's a chance, however slim.
Did you know Hunt well? Even if he is, he left us to die. That's no captain.
Not at all. Rather, he knew... That's not important. Apologies, I'm rambling. I suppose you wanted an update on the crew. They seem to be faring well, all things considered.
A report would be nice. Mostly scrapes and scuffs. As for the dogs, you're better asking... The kennel master. You mean Cordell?
Yes, Cordell.
I haven't taken well to the dogs. I'm unsure how to carry myself amidst most people, and animals are more quick to judge.
And Cordell herself is harsh as still. He probably is out there, frozen to death, if they were just in a little boat.
If they were in a little boat, though. But you can rely on me for any human medical issues.
Nutley pauses for a moment. Is everything, good? I mean, is someone coming to rescue us?
Everything's under control. I won't lie. We're in a difficult situation here. I'm going to need your help.
He nods expectantly.
Nutley keeps his head low.
I can take a look at the injured now.
The mate bay.
Wait, what? Okay, I'm not entirely sure. What am I supposed to do? Oh, I'm supposed to look for the guy who's hurt. Yeah. I'll see what I can do.
Right, so our guy is there now. Should be fine. Let's go below deck and see what we can do.
Kasha. Officer. Captain Shaw. I suppose I should get used to calling you that. I was asking the crew if anyone had seen Hunt or any of the deserters last night. Not a single soul. I know the man knows the ship well, but that seems odd. Do you think the crew could be lying?
I wouldn't accuse anyone of that, but it is very unlikely that he wasn't seen by anyone.
Dude, this game feels like it's setting up to be some kind of murder mystery. Are you going to be checking out the new Doctor Strange movie today? It's out now in theaters. Avalanche, I will not. Even if I wanted to, it's already 8 o'clock here in South Africa, so there's no way I'm doing it now. But I won't be going to the theater, no.
I suppose the boiler troubles caused a great deal of distraction.
I think I know what happened.
What if the boiler problems happened because Captain Hunt and those three soldiers were thrown into the boiler? What if we have a murderer on the ship?
Oh wait, fuck. Almost put... No, what was I doing?
Wait, can you put people in here? You can, actually. But I don't think we have many people here, do we?
Actually, let's just do this. Yeah.
For now, at least. Let's keep old Timmy doing that. Feed the hosh pot. Wait, that's not right.
Okay, that's fine. There we go. What if we have a murderer on the ship? Better check your food then.
Well, what am I supposed to do? I can't catch the murderer right now.
The murderer is, for now at least, the fucking murderer. Raid room.
What the hell is in here?
Alright, apparently I'm not supposed to know yet.
A assigned to shovel coal. Fuck, who do we assign to shovel coal?
Speculation, by the way, not a spoiler. I never touched this game yet.
Avalanche, no. I'm not thinking that you are spoiling things.
Yeah, fuck the scientists. Just throw that bastard right in here to shovel some coal.
They're not going to be fucking happy. There's a scientist that's being put to work.
Lol. Coal goes in, we stay alive. It's really that simple. Alright, that's it. That's all I needed. Furnace is full.
Right. Okay. Do we have anything that we should be doing here? We've taken requests. We've sent out scouts. So now we can sort of, I think, start the end of the day. The crew have their meal.
Har, shall we give a toast to our new captain? Hear, hear.
They're warming up to me. In preparation for the evening, you can't help but notice that it's still bright light outside.
Let's speak to Junior.
Evening, Shaw. I'm proud of what I've been able to cook up for the crew lately, considering the rations. Though I do wish I had something better to work with. I'd kill for a good beef steak. Not many cows on the ice. You do excellent work, Junior. You have a knack for this.
You're in an eons-old land of frozen death, even if there wasn't that city deep in the interior. That is the last place on Earth you'd want to be.
Down Periscope, these men love me.
Science is of -4 to strength and +4 to intellect. Digging coal is going to be bad. I don't think there is such a thing in this game, Pringles, but it would be cool if people had attributes.
I've been told. Hunt would say he couldn't eat a bite that wasn't prepared by me anymore.
Well, good for you, bro. Let's speak to Gimli.
Did you need me for something?
I simply wanted to learn more of you, Gimli. You served with Captain Hunt for quite some time. Tell me about him.
The crew seems to like you. I wondered if you had any advice staying on their good side.
Not much to know. I'm the carpenter. I'm Junior's brother. I play music. You know it all already.
Wow. What a fucking asshole.
You're a tall one, aren't you?
Oh, thank you for noticing. Been this big since I was 15.
You ever consider doing films? You have the stature for it.
Oh, I can't act.
Acting isn't part of it. You stand there, got a nice silhouette, and you'd be a star.
That sounds awfully easy, doesn't it?
It can be.
Is it really that simple to be a star?
So tired. You'll get used to it, lad. Duh. It's far too much work.
Thought you wanted the work.
If I can do it with one arm, you can do it. You're always saying that, Da.
Looks like we'll be trapped here for a while.
Aye. I don't like the ship's chances either. It'll be some time before we see home.
Shit. I'm going to die of boredom out here before the call takes me.
You'll manage, I'm sure.
Let's go up.
Awfully loud, aren't they?
I don't mind it all that much. They've worked hard all day. They're owed their leisure.
Those sailors ought to remember. We all need our sleep.
Alright, the scientists are not happy. Enter Kurt's room.
Jesus, look at this Kurt. Look at Kurt's room.
Evening, Shaw. Cold one, isn't it?
I used to think I was growing used to the cold.
But as the years have gone on, the elements have only grown harsher on the body. That's to be expected, Kurt. You're getting old.
I imagine this is a harsher area than you've ever faced.
You'd be surprised, Captain.
I ought to tell you of a few bad scrapes in my time.
Alright, so you guys do realize that I don't have
I don't have a first mate currently.
Good evening, Captain. It will be some time before we see rescue. Perhaps you should be endearing yourself to your crew. For now, I'd like to learn more of you. I notice you're quite invested in my captaincy. You'll find that I am invested in our survival. That is tied to how you continue to lead.
Yeah, yeah. Pet the dog. You rub its chin. Pet the dog. You pat its back. Pet the dog. You tickle it behind the ears. Speak to her.
Captain Shaw, I presume you're here to see the dogs.
Yes, how are they faring? Actually, I was checking on you. You aren't with the rest of the crew.
Time to knock out some dailies. Have a lunch. Enjoy, bro.
Of course I'm not. Do you often expect others to leave their post? I understand you did not expect this role, but you are the captain regardless. Surely you understand a sense of duty.
Captain Shaw, you recall my conditions with Hunt, do you not? Like it was yesterday.
My demand was that I work here, with the dogs. Your people may help with the sleds, but they are not my responsibility. They are not my people. I am holding up my promise with Hunt. I do not intend to join your crew.
The dogs beside her bark. How long have you been raising dogs? If I can get lost in the ice, you're the next captain, Stanbury.
If I get lost in the ice, you're the next captain, Stanbury.
Oh, Stanbury is the dog. Never mind. Woof. Whatever. Quiddell smiles, confused.
I think I just named the dog as the next captain. Might not be the best idea, but you know, whatever. Alright, so now we're moving on, I think. Pretty sure there's nothing else that we can do here. Maybe? No, there's nothing else we can do. I don't think.
Alright, I've spoken to him. Spoken to him. He stares at you before an orange hammock.
Alright, here we go. Next day. Next week, actually.
Fuck. We'll be losing more decorum.
So more food. We could give them double rations and get some decorum back, but we'll lose a cunt ton of food. We could do double fuel as well, and that puts us almost max. I think we'll go, let's do this. Just for this week. Yeah, for this week we'll do this.
It's cure for the steam burns. Okay, start next week.
We have one available crew. 2 weeks at Temperance Camp.
The hell is here?
Oh, crap. Wait a second, there's a... What? This is how he did it. That's how the bastard got away from us so quickly. Because there's a... secret passage there.
Lol.
Alright, into the captain's cabin. Let's take requests.
Yorick the Third.
Captain, news from our scouts north. We discovered 2 penguin spots, Emperor and Adeli, respectively. Also discovered a spot where crab-eater seals gather. They're marked on the map if you wish to send out a hunting party.
Thank you.
Flick. Captain, news from our scout east. Crab-eater seals and Emperor penguins both gathering in those areas. They're marked on the map if you wish to send out a hunting party.
Junior.
Shaw, Templeton, word back from the attempts freeing the ship.
Is such a report necessary?
Well, as you can see, we're not moving. Crew kept at it for a week, but now we're calling it a day. A waste of time and resources then, as expected.
I wouldn't be so sure. End of the day, at least now, the crew can say they tried. Gave it their all. The old college try. There's something in that.
That is true, Kasha.
Good day, Captain.
Well, as good as it can be under the circumstances.
Good day to you as well, Kasha. Is there anything you require?
I don't have time for greetings at the moment, Kasha.
Well, I'll be sure to spare you any more obligatory small talk from here. In truth, there is something I've been meaning to ask you. It's a matter I brought up with Captain Hunt, though he was less receptive. I'm not merely interested in the story of this expedition. I'm interested in the story of the people on this expedition. When the crew have the downtime, I would request that I be allowed to conduct interviews with them. I would like to know more about them. Maybe learn more about what happened to Hunt. I see no issue there. Conduct an interview as you please.
We don't have time for this at the moment, Kasha. Another time, perhaps.
That's all well and good for you, but what are we to gain? Well, I'm sure I'm not the only one to find use in knowledge. This crew are like strangers to you, are they not? You could stand to learn more of them as well. I'll add anything relevant I find to the crew manifest. Just send them to the lower deck raid room and I can get started.
I see no issue there.
Conduct an interview as you please.
Thank you, Captain. You won't regret it.
As I said, I'll mark anything useful I discover in the crew manifest. It's another mistake.
Let's screenshot this.
And there we go. Mint penguin are my fave.
What is mint penguin?
You mean to eat? Have you ever eaten penguin actually?
Send them to the red room and lower deck, then when you can.
Alright, gnomes. Word around the crew is that we might end up having to move to the ice. If we can't free the Temperance anyway. Would be wise to gather what we want to take off ship with us if we do.
Indeed. We'll need to prepare for what could be the inevitable.
Aye. Most of the tools are in the lower deck storerooms. The metal doors need some work to open, but it's worth what's inside.
Penguins are a chocolate biscuit bar in the UK?
I have never fucking heard of it.
Thorbog.
Captain Shaw, Mr. Templeton. It would appear that some of the crew have taken an interest in the transmission radios we have on hand. It is likely many of their first time seeing this technology. And they have odd ideas of what they're capable of. They believe another ship may pick us up if we monitor them. Ridiculous. They do not have the range to pick up another, not out here. I said as much, but they were adamant we spend the night monitoring them regardless. Even sent me to run the concept by you, Captain. It's worth the attempt, even if it's to ensure... Just to ensure the crew.
We wore tuxes all day?
Do I need to do this? We're already at 100% decorum. It's not like we need more decorum, but maybe... Maybe we find something interesting, so we may as well, right?
So we basically want to say, put one of the scientists. Let's put this guy on it. Just because, you know. Yeah.
Wait, didn't I?
I thought I fucking did it.
There we go. Oh, I need to put two of them.
Shit.
Anyways. So with the attempt, even if just to ensure the crew. That does seem fair. At least this way, the crew will be certain. Yes. Otherwise, they will ponder the alternative until we're all frozen. Finish the requests.
Let's listen. Ah, feel that air. Nothing better than a cold wind to keep you awake.
You're an odd duck, Yorick III. How many hours of sleep do you get a night?
Well, I... On second thought, better not hearing it. I already know it isn't enough.
So how do I send out a hunting party?
Oh, like this.
Do you guys think we should...
What are we hunting? What do you think we should hunt first? Crab-eater seals or penguins? Oh, before we do this, let's send out a scouting party. To this here area. And to this here area, we can send out another scout. Oh, fuck. Now I can't actually pick up anything. So we don't have dogs. Yep, we don't have dogs. Fuck. Fuck those seals. Well, at least now we'll be able to discover everything. So, once we've discovered it, we can go grab the food that is there. So, that's fine. Should work, at least. Okay, let's see. Anyone we need to talk to here? No. How about here? Let's get some tinned food. Let's... Wait, fuck it. Get one of the scouts in here to do this. Feed the harsh pond. There we go. Okay, that takes us to full food. Although... Let's confirm first and let's see what happens now. So this is going to put plus 40. Yeah, we'll waste too much there. So screw it. Return. Shit. What's this? Into the food hold. Into the tools hold. Into the engineer's hold. So now I need to put people on this to actually enter... Confirm. Leave. Confirm. You and two Johns charge into the room. It is full of food and ale. With the water flooding in from behind, you have time to grab one item. Wait, what? Are we taking on water? The ship is actually sinking. Let's grab the ale. The room is flooded, rendering the rest of the items useless. Fuck. I don't know why, though. Like, what the hell happened? You and Run charge into the room. It is full of weapons, flares, and explosives. With the water flooding in from behind, you have... Dude, what the fuck is going on? Why is there water in my goddamn place? A weathered game rifle with high stopping power, bolt action. Hunting shotgun. An old-fashioned double-barrel buckshot rifle, suitable for hunting birds. Bright light and heat without an explosion, for altering humans and alarming wildlife. Controlled explosives for clearing pressure ridges and exploding matter. Alright, what do we take? I don't know, but the water is damaging shit here. Do you guys think the hunting shotgun, the explosives? Random Mage, thanks for the follow, dude. Really appreciate that. Welcome to the channel. Thank you. I don't think you can take... I think you can only take one. We'll take the hunting shotgun. There is enough time to grab one more item. Oh, shit. Okay, we can grab one more item. Go with explosives here. You rescue the explosives.
rendering the rest of the items useless. What happened here, though? Nothing. There's just nothing in there. How is there water flowing into the fucking... Man, this makes no sense, man. There's water flowing into the... flowing into the ship here, and yet... They get to work. Alright, good job. Let's see. You. Confirm orders. You and Runstar charge into the room. It's full of various tools and specialist equipment. With the water flooding in from behind, you have time to grab two items. Inspect the medical tools. The doctor should be able to see more than one patient at a time with these. Inspect the digging tools. These should make quick work against pressure ridges and protect against injuries attempting to reverse them. Inspect the engineering tools. These tools could be used to increase the capacity of either a hooshpot or the furnace. Inspect the carpenter. These should make it easier to extract timber and use it for repairs. Fuck. All right. Thargonian. Thank you for the follow, dude. Really appreciate that. Welcome to the channel. Thank you. So what do we take, chat? I feel like our best bet is engineering tools and maybe carpentry tools. Yeah, definitely engineering tools. We can take two. We can grab one more item here. You guys agree? Carpentering. In case we need to make repairs. And we have one final room that we can enter into. Oh, this room isn't being flooded. Oh, what a coinkydink. Anyone free for an interview and a portrait? Not really. Well, I'll give you one of the engineers. There you go. They join the photographer. Great. Alright, I think that's it. I'm not sure... yeah, let's call everyone. The crew have their meal. The dinner is shared. Okay, good. The crew returns to their post. The hammocks are unfold. Bright light outside. Perhaps it's flooding my magic. Random mage, thanks for the first time chat. Did really appreciate that. That's my thinking, at least at the moment. You know, as far as rations go, this is good. Junior sure knows how to prepare a dinner, doesn't he? He's too good for a ship like this. Alright. Evening. Before we took off, Grimly and I stopped into a greasy spoon in the city. Their sausage and egg was perfect. Best I ever had. Now I'm trying to remember its damned name. Sniffed my head. I didn't take you for the sort to enjoy the city. Why didn't you write it down? It was likely by the docks. Just look around once we return, you'll find it. If it's still there when we return... Who knows when we'll be back? They could have closed down or fired their chef by then. That or its pipes, the rooms flooding, are all in the middle of the ship. Could be pipes. I guess. Alright, it's you're pretty old, aren't ya? Good eye, lad. Better than mine. Why are you still working? You should be at home with your family. Don't have one. Do you not have any children? I might do. Don't know any, though. Okay. More of the same tonight. We'll have to get used to it. Not much you can do with the ice. We'll figure out something to do, won't we? We'll have to. Let's hear what Grimly has to say. It's getting harder to play. The cold makes the fingers stiff. Power through it, for the crew's sake.
Have you tried playing closer to the furnace?
Not the same. Besides, Hammond would just throw the accordion in.
Lol. Alright, do we have anyone? Here we go. Anything? Afraid not. I didn't expect anything to come of it. Well, at least we can say we tried.
Good evening, Captain. Was there something you needed?
If you need the latest medical report, I'll have it prepared soon.
How have you been handling your nerves lately, Doctor?
Oh, that. Well, I'm trying to maintain composure, but anxieties are hard to avoid, given the circumstances.
But wait, that was midsection of the ship, so that's not it.
What?
Maybe water around is freezing and expansion breaks the hull?
Yeah, but it's in the middle of the ship. You would expect the boiler to be the first place to get fucked by the ice if that is gonna happen.
The boiler room, right?
So, yeah, I'm not entirely sure.
Alright, let's see. At the bow, you spot Kurt, measuring for any changes in the temperature. Still fast, no signs of any change. He notices you and gives a wave.
Doubt we'll be moving anytime soon, Captain.
Of course, sometimes you never know with the ice. You should get some rest. I'll let you know if anything changes.
See that you get some rest yourself.
I will. But we have to be alert. In my experience, change come fast. Take care, Captain.
How did they sail in the olden days through ice sheets like this?
Captain, a word? I felt now as good a time as any to review the wording in our contracts. You do remember what was written in your contract?
Why is that relevant now? To be honest, I only skimmed the thing. I was already sold on the job.
Well, I suggest you become more acquainted in the future. Consider Article 3, and I quote, "The member of the staff shall throughout the period of such expedition obey all commands of the captain and shall use his best endeavors to promote the success of the same."
Let him continue. "And in the event of anything happening to the captain, shall obey all commands of any member of the staff who shall be appointed by the captain in writing before his death. It being understood that the rest of the staff shall hold the same relations towards any member of the staff so appointed as towards the captain, appointed by the captain in writing before his death."
Zigzags, how you doing, brother?
No, I'm alerting you to a potential issue. The vote we held settled what is only a temporary arrangement in the eyes of the law. Even then, you only made it through by a hair. Unless you somehow managed to wrestle a written transfer of captainship from Hunt before his departure, in the eyes of the law, you are simply acting in his stead, with no legal recourse to call upon. There is a chance Hunt and the deserters are still out there. Should we be reunited, your captainship will indeed be called into question. The crew are unlikely to choose a deserter over me. I see no issue in that. Wouldn't it be good to have our captain return? Templeton, why are you so invested in the captainship?
I am invested in the survival of this mission and providing appropriate guidance. You may presume an ulterior motive, but you know my reasoning is sound. The loyalty of the crew means everything.
Get them on your side, Shaw. Keep them on your side.
That will come naturally. I do not intend to disappoint.
I see. Thank you for bringing this to my attention, Templeton.
I have more important matters to deal with than a piece of paper. We will see.
Remember my words, Shaw. I suggest you start with the Stoke brothers. It seems they speak for many of the sailors.
But how do I get the Stoke brothers on my side? I'm not entirely fucking sure.
I speak to them every day, but nothing really happens.
Right. I think we're done for the day. So, here we go. Next week. Let's go back down to half. Sure, we lost a little bit of... We're going to lose a little bit of composure. But I think that's fine to spare some of our resources. Templeton may have been the one who killed everyone, actually. He might be the one who killed... what's it called? Oh, shit. The meeting. Templeton, Kurt, Cordell, and Hammond stand inside. The beginnings of a meeting. Well, Captain, it's been 3 weeks. Kurt tells me there's still no change in the ice. None. And best I can estimate, what change we will see won't free the ship. I'd predict the Temperance is more likely to be crushed under the pressure of the ice. And how long will that take? A few weeks at most? Unfortunately, we may have to look at alternatives to waiting for the ice to break up. Are you certain it's a lost cause? I don't like the idea of leaving the ship. You never know, but from what I've seen, I wouldn't take the chance. Leaving the Temperance and making camp on the ice is something we will have to consider. Aye, the longer we stay on the ship, the more fuel we're having to burn. Not to mention risking another boiler incident. Yes, that matter almost cost lives. I want to represent you, smoldering, but you can't. I'm representing myself here. I am the captain. Heating a smaller camp burns through much less oil. And without enough fuel to survive the winter, we're dead. Don't think I need to tell you that. I would not be quite so quick to pack up and move on just yet. And why is that? The ship is shelter. The ship is safety. Certainly, there are quite a few hunting opportunities presented to us. We will need to gather more food if we are to survive, and the ship provides a safe area to hunt from. Right. And most of the crew aren't ready to give up either. They're stubborn, just as any good crew should be. I would rather not play into stubbornness when lives are on the line. He has a point. Crew thinks he gave up too early. They'll resent the captain for it. Though we now have a serious bloody flooding problem.
We do?
Aye. You might have noticed if you'd left your damn forecastle. It is safer to take the time to gather what we need before we leave, rather than raid the ship once we make ice. Well, the answer lies with the captain. Should we move off the ship this week? Not yet. We'll remain on the ship for now.
Fuck, what do you guys think? Do we move off the ice or do we remain on the ship for another week? We already have a serious flooding problem. So things could be really bad.
Remain on the ship for now. Very well. When we remove the boiler from the furnace, that is when we make our move. When we feel we're ready to go, just go to the boiler room and give the order. Okay, that's good. We're remaining. I'm trusting you, chat. If we don't fucking make it off, fuck you all. Captain, news from our scout to the south. Crab eater seals are gathering in this area. Elephant seals are located not far off either. They're marked on the map if you wish to send out a hunting party. Captain, news from our scout west. In that direction, we'll find crab eater seals and Adelic penguins. They're marked on the map if you wish to send out a hunting party. Mr. Gloss, Captain, we tried to use the radios to pick up any signals every evening for the past week. Nothing, I take it? Afraid not. As we expected. I have to say, though, I expected a worse reaction from the sailors. I suppose there's a relief in trying a method and knowing it to be unsuccessful. Now they can move on to the next venture with little reservation. They are resourceful people, I must say. Well, I suppose anything that puts the crew's mind at ease is worth doing. Thank you, Mr. Glossley. Cordell. Captain,
My dogs appear to be struggling in the on-deck kennels. They require a more secure form of shelter from the environment. Dogloos, I believe they are called? Yes, I will require some hands to work on constructing them. It is for the health and safety of the pack. I'll put some of the crew to work on it. The dogs are secure enough. I don't see reason to bolt them another shelter. I'm afraid I cannot spare the hands. The dogs will just have to make do. Thank you. We must focus on keeping the dogs safe. Without them, the crew stands little chance of safety themselves. Sure, it's safe to say we've been out here longer than anticipated. We're going to have to organize the rations we have. Find out what expires first. That way, we won't be letting anything go to waste. Long process, though. Could use a hand or two to help, if you can assign them to the pantry. Tucker. Mast was damaged when the ship was being tossed a while back, Captain. Best got someone to fix it, before the Temperance is freed. Freed? Aye, ship could come loose any moment. Heading up to repair the mast is a dangerous task. We don't even know if the ship will sail if the ice clears. Would be worth it, though. Fuck, do you guys think it's worth? Rather avoid that. Suit yourself, then. I think for now, because we can always fix it again. I was summoned by Mr. Templeton. Yes, Mr. Isaac. This is regarding your personal item. What do you mean? I felt it pertinent to let the captain know that you are carrying a weapon. Excuse me? Perhaps this is my unfamiliarity with expeditions, but I was surprised others did not bring an item to protect themselves. Many of the crew cannot afford such an item to themselves. Captain, it is up to you on what to do with this revolver. With all due respect, this is my personal item, Captain. It is the captain's right to requisition any weapons on the ship. That includes your own. You're free to hold on to it, Mr. Zack. Be careful. I cannot allow a single person to hold on to a weapon. Hand over the revolver, Mr. Zack. That weapon will be more useful in the hands of Cordell for hunts. Do we take his weapon or do we give the weapon to Cordell? I think for hunts. Very well, Captain. I understand. We would do well to avoid creating an imbalance of power among the crew. I doubt the sailors would take too kindly to such a thing. Sure. There's a rumor going around amongst the crew. They're saying the ship is haunted by the ghost of Captain Hunt. What ridiculous tripe. I thought you'd want to put a stop to it. Absolutely. We can't allow rumors like that to run rampant. They're just stories. I see no harm in them. But what are we gonna do? But why am I losing decorum if I tell them, no, it's not haunted? Fine, confirm it. Absolutely, we can't allow rumors like that. Aye. Crew won't be best pleased you're stopping their stories. It's better than allowing fear and superstition to run wild. Aye. Finish the reports. Head to the boiler when you wish to abandon ship. I suggest we do so sooner rather than later. Actually, I suggest we go hunt first. Alright, so we are crab-eater seals, elephant seals. I think we should send... not that. A scout. Which scout? Where's Cordell? Who the fuck is Cordell? Cordell is the dog master, no? Oh, she goes to hunt anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Plus one elephant seal. Plus one elephant seal. Plus one elephant seal.
That's a lot of elephant seals, no? Scarecrow lady, how you doing? No, I haven't. Right. I don't think we can put anyone else out. We don't have any more scouts. Well, we could probably. Can you move anyone else? Maybe we shouldn't. I mean, how good would other people be on this? I am, Scarecrow Lady. Thank you so much for asking. Yeah, I don't think we can put these guys on this. They fuck. What do you guys think? Fuck, this could be a problem. Because we sent all of our scouts to that on that mission. No, I think if you send sailors, they're gonna get lost because they don't know how to use the dogs. Well, look, you do get people. That's fine, as you can see there. You do get your seals. The issue is just, what if they get lost? Then you've just lost all of your fucking people. For other tasks? Yeah, we'll leave this for now. Confirm. Wait, what? Did I not? Why can't I leave? Confirm your orders. What? I click return. I can't return. I'm pretty sure I did. All of the scouts are synced out. There's no more anything that I want to do. All right, fine. Let's see what happens. Let's just send one. Okay, well, if we lose this guy, fuck you guys. Okay, let's see what other tasks there is to do here. Feed the hoshpot. Confirm your orders. Return. Oh, the guy actually wanted... Fuck. Things are now getting bad in here, so... My spoiled tinned food. Fuck my life. But okay. Well, this isn't great. Look at... Everything's gonna be under... Oh, shit! Alright, not good, people. Not fucking good. Not good. Oh my god. How is this place still going? I mean, this place is still going. No fucking problemo. Leave. There's water here as well. Okay, so let's assign people to shovel coal. Confirm your orders. I don't know what else to do. They said we should... Call everyone. Your heat is maxed. Yeah, but
get that call out as soon as possible before we have to fucking leave? Oh yeah, we have to do the dog loose. Yeah, we'll do that as well. Return to their post. The hammocks are unfold, but how do I do the dog loose? And I swear, when that hook came swinging, Captain Hunt had to pull me down. This was 5-6 years ago? I had no clue what I was doing. Both of us nearly lost an eye that day. Same expedition, Walt lost his arm. Half the time, I don't think Hunt knew what he was doing either. I'm sure he did. He seemed a good captain. He was quite an interesting man. Well, you have a new captain now. I'll steer you, right? Aye, he is. Did you need something? I heard stories about Hunt, and I was curious. I'd like to know more about the man. Okay, let's hear. Didn't get your full while he was here, eh? Worried about the vote, aren't you? Oh, is that it, Shaw? Why would I be worried? The vote passed, and I am the captain. I'm curious why you voted the way you did. I don't care about that. I genuinely am checking in. Let's see if they believe us. Are you now? All right. Let's leave it at that, Gimli. Nice of you to check in, Shaw. But I think it's time the crew called it a night. Dude, how do you make friends with these two fucking brothers? They hate my guts and I haven't done shit to them. I've done nothing. They just don't like me. He should learn to show some respect. I'm his captain. This crew was awfully fond of Hunt. Is there an issue I'm not aware of? A word to the wise, Robin. I have nothing against you, but we sure don't know you either. It's going to take more than simple pleasantries to earn Gimli's trust. Yeah, I'm sure. Missed the water. Got used to playing on a rocking ship. Starting to feel sick when I'm off too long. This too, I assure you. I miss it myself. That sense of constant movement. Nothing else like it. Okay, we're chatting to these brothers now. Let's see. Aye, you get it. Don't like stillness. I like feeling like I'm going somewhere. Maybe that won us a bit. You ever have pancakes, Shaw? Served some for Captain Hunt once, and he started demanding them every time. Can only have them early on into a trip, though. Ingredients don't keep that long. I'm sure you can make something similar with what we have. Hunt was fond of your cooking, wasn't he? He hired me. It would be odd if he wasn't. He didn't take me on as a charity, Shaw. Hunt's not the type of type for that. Dude, what the fuck? These guys are weird. All right, fine. Now let's go see how the fuck do we build the boogaloo thingies or whatever. Here we go. It was good to hear that sailor's That sailor 7. Hold up, just quickly screenshotting that. All right. Brother, excuse me, Captain. Would you like to go fuck yourself? Yeah, pretty much. If nothing else, we can take solace in avoiding a life being lost today. So how do I build this? Good evening, Captain. Will this take long? The dogs are fed and rested. However, I dislike leaving them alone. You've trained them well. There won't be any issue. Over to these mutts. Do you dislike leaving the dogs, or do you dislike joining the crew? That would be my hope, but you can never be certain. Okay, I don't know how I'd build this thing that they want me to build. I don't think I can, if I'm honest with you. Let's see if we... Where the hell is Kurt? Oh, did I send Kurt away? Speak to Hammond. Bloody cold, isn't it, Captain? Do you know how you spend your time away from the furnace? You grow used to it. You're used to the warmth of the furnace. A furnace, I take it. It would be even colder without your hard work, Hammond. Aye, I know.
I don't know if I would really play this on my own, but standing here watching it being played is feeling so good. Up they go, you're really enjoying it. Shit on the brother's bed. Trust me, Amator be well. You click on the dog paw icon in the midday. That would have worked, I think. Come to the furnace if I'm babbling. Right. All right, so we've tried. I think that's it, guys. I think just skip the day and go on to the next one. You know what we do need? Is a way to see how much food we actually have left. You know what, we'll do fuel full, just to get a bit more decorum. Alright, week 7, 4 weeks at Temperance Camp. Right, let's see. That young woman, Kasha, the flash of her camera has startled my dogs several times now. It is growing tiresome. Cameras have a flash. It's unavoidable. Are they respectable photographs, at least? I do not care to ask. I'm already fully aware of how my dogs appear. Still, that camera is her sole purpose out here. As much as an annoyance it can be, it would not be right to rob her of that. Good job. I'm enjoying watching Echo kill his crew. Dude, how do you know? Like, not anyone in my crew is dead yet. Bullshit. Alright, let's start taking... Tony Grimley. Sure. Put a stop to those rumors going on about Hunt. That simple? The sailors do seem to listen to you. Aye. You'll not be hearing them whispers again. Nice. Captain, I would find it wise to have a word with the journalist among our crew. For whatever reason, Hunt allowed for a photographer with no sailing experience to tail alongside this expedition. As it stands, Kasha Balfour's record is what will stand the test of time when this expedition is spoken of, and it would seem she has not made allies of the crew. Kasha, she doesn't seem the type to make enemies. Not with purpose or malice, Captain. The sailors of this crew are a private lot. They do not take kindly to the prying eyes of a landlubber, as they would say. Remember, Captain, she controls the story. She controls your story. Mad Beastie, how you doing, brother? Best to have a word. Yeah, I still don't quite... Okay, let's send out a proper group here. Let's go crab eater seals, scouts... Send one scout, maybe a couple of sailors. Let's get some penguins. Fuck it. And we can send one. There we go. Okay, I'm still not entirely sure when am I... Jesus. Alright, this place is now frozen over, bro. VTX, how you doing, bro? Rusted sustain... Sustenance prepared by the Apron Tinning Company... Soggily exhumed from the Temperance. Spoiled tinned food. Guess that's fine. It's old school fun. This game is really cool. Return. Dude, this place is a fucking mess. I'm still not sure what this room is supposed to be, but okay. I can probably put a couple of sailors on here to get more of this food out.
And I still don't quite... Oh, well, fucking hell, I should have clicked that. Dinner is interrupted by a torrent of flooding. Hopeless, 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 hopeless. God. Hey, that was not... The crew are alarmed. Frantic arguments break out about taking the furnace and abandoning ship right now. Couldn't shake the feeling. There was a pair of eyes on me while I was working there. Yes, I'm sure there's a terrible undiscovered beast lurking in the mist. You're overworked. You should get some proper rest. The isolation might be getting to you. I get sleep when I can, and I often can't. That's just how it is. Dude, this is not good. This is not fucking good. You guys realize that? We are in deep trouble. Dr. Nutley? Mr. Templeton? I trust all is going well? Well as can be. It was good to see Mr. Hammond make his recovery. All thanks to your expertise, I take it. I tried my best. You should continue to do so. We wish not any further incidents. Captain, is there anything you miss? I don't mean anything important. I'm sure there are people you miss. I mean, small comforts. Does warmth qualify as a small comfort? Well, you certainly aren't alone there. I doubt I'll ever grow used to the cold. Personally, I miss tea. I would drink a cup every morning and right before sleep. I didn't think I would miss such a simple habit so much. Dude, I could do with a cup of coffee right now. Captain, if you find yourself stricken with boredom, I do have a book I would recommend. A textbook on different classes of wildflowers. The topic is more interesting than it may seem, I assure you. I do not imagine that a book on wildflowers would be interesting. Don't say we, you're the one that fucked it. Dude, how did I fuck it? This is a topic that fascinates you? I doubt that will have much application on the ice. Let's just say yes. Don't want to lose him. I'll be sure to bring it to you when you have a chance then. Thanks. I appreciate this. At least my room is not flooded yet. Let's go up. I genuinely don't know how to leave the ice. Pat its head. Ruffle its fur. Bark at you. Next to my kennels would often play music on a phonograph. I would hear it through the open window for months on end. I would hear it as I worked. Over time, I had grown used to it. I'm sure one of the crew brought a phonograph. Perhaps you can pick up the habit once more? This is not needed. I would not attempt to impose in such a way. Dude, you're gonna have to chill the fuck out. But they did say if I'm ready to move off the ice, I need only go to the boiler room. I mean, here's the boiler room. How the fuck do I get off the ice? Oh, like this. Jesus. All right. Furnace is torn from the boiler. We're heading out then. Best tell the lads. We're moving out? Yes, captain's orders. For now, we should focus on setting up a campsite on the ice. Leave the equipment hauling for later? No worries. I'll get them to work. We'll have a camp set up before you know it. Wait, I thought we were already grabbing the equipment. You're taking that with you? Aye. Can't go a day without it, can you? Oi, the crew like the music. Fair enough. You better get to hauling them lifeboat next.
They're a bit more important than an accordion.
I know.
Calm, Stanberry. We're simply moving to the ice.
Yes, yes. It's all very exciting. It's the rest of you. If the rest of you behave yourselves, you will be treated to an extra helping of soup.
Well, there we have it. The heart of the ship ripped clean from her chest, but she still beats for the crew. How long were you waiting on that one?
Well, because it was shite. No time for poetry.
Just like that. The guy was trying to be philosophical and the sailor is just like, did that shit. So the ice moves. My mom told me to grow a pair and I informed her that hurt me emotionally.
Well, that's how you do it, Captain. Let's get this bloody furnace set up on the ice.
Right. What am I supposed... Oh, key items. Confirm your orders.
Kind of like Frostpunk, sure.
Dude, these people must be so fucking cold, though. It must be so fucking cold there, though. What are you doing up there?
Now's the last chance to get a shot like this.
Isn't that dangerous?
Don't worry, I've done it before. Don't tell the captain.
Okay, they're perfect. Farewell, Temperance.
Empath Echo, ladies and gentlemen.
Captain, I hope your new lodgings are to your comfort. If not, I'm afraid you will have to power through until rescue. We say goodbye to the Temperance, for our work is far from over. Nothing to protect us from the ice now. We weren't going to get anywhere holding on to that anchor.
Agreed. Rescuing equipment from the ship is our chief priority, Captain. Without the furnace, the Temperance is quite literally dead in the water. 3 weeks at most before it goes under. We need to prioritize what exactly we will need to take with us. We won't have the time to retrieve it all. Food and coal seems the most important. We'll need guns for the hunt. We'll need as many tools and equipment as possible.
Fuck, which one do we need?
I feel like hunting is very important, but tools and equipment is important too.
Like, you can get food, we already have guns. But without tools and equipment, you're fucked.
Uplink, alright, take care of yourself, bro. Thank you very much for hanging out, man. Really appreciate it.
We'll need as many tools and equipment as possible.
Fuck, chat. What do we do? What do we do? What do we do? I don't know what to do.
Alright, let's do that. We'll need as many tools and equipment as possible. Of course, we'll need assistance navigating the ice, and I'm certain our doctor would prefer his medical comforts were saved. Regardless, we need our wits about us. We stand alone against the ice now.
So is it possible to, enter the captain's request tent?
Yorick III. A crew member approaches you during dinner. Captain, you look like you could use some more to eat. Taking up the responsibility of captain is an admirable as it is unenviable. Please, help yourself to some of my own rations. Frankly, I'm stuffed.
Thank you, but there's no need. That's rather kind of you. I have no time for
toadying. You needn't attempt it.
Thank you, but there is no need.
Oh, well, the offer is always there.
Yorick III returns to their seated position as others in the crew look at them with annoyed expressions. It would appear their attempts at gratifying command was unsuccessful.
Fuck. So I should have accepted it? I thought I was being nice. I thought I was being nice by saying, no, don't worry about it, dude. I'm good. It's all good. It's all good in the hood. Don't worry about it.
What will it be today, sir?
More than enough food. It's more than enough heat. And there I was, face to face with a leopard seal. Dangerous creatures cannot be mistaken for your average seal. Natural hunters, much faster on land than you'd expect. How'd you deal with that thing? I was lucky. I had my hunting shotgun at the ready. We were feasting on leopard seal that night. Of course, of all the times the crew weren't filming, pull the other one. It's true. This other time, we... Kurt continues to ramble on. It seems he will be at this for a while. Of course he will. You get your photo snapped by that photographer too? Aye. She's a landlubber for sure, treating us like we're some novelty. I don't much have a problem with it. Good conversation at least. I'd rather less good conversation out here. Alright. Let's talk to Kasha. As you pass by, you see Kasha adjusting her camera as she stands, partially obscured, as she finds the right angle for shots. As you step to her side, she raises her head and looks to you. What are you taking photos of? Do you ever stop taking pictures? Why don't you join the camp proper? The crew, of course. This is quite the unique situation we're in. I want to capture the mood. Maybe I should place it beside our initial crew photos. Compare and contrast. Oh, that's brilliant. You don't have to capture everything, you know. You can join the others if you wish. Kasha's eyes dart to the crew, briefly lingering on the stature of Kurt, then back to you. I think I'm better off in the background, taking pictures from a distance. Do you dislike Kurt? Kill all the baby seals? I'm gonna. Not at all. I don't like Kurt, dislike Kurt. It's simply that I followed Kurt's expeditions a lot as a child, so seeing him in person is odd. Kurt doesn't bite. He certainly barks quite loudly at that. But you're right, I'm just being nervous. It's more that up until now, he's been an idea. Does that make any sense? Kurt is just another person like you or I. This is serious, Kasha. Now is hardly the time to have a celebrity crisis. I suppose so. Well, I'll leave you be. I'm still looking for the right shot. Let's speak to Hammond. Contained to the furnace if I'm yabbing to you. Knight. Wow. Fucking asshole. Oh, for fuck's sake. Whoa, my mouse is gone now? Fucking hell. There we go. Back at it. What about him? I must retire for the evening. I will see you for the morning requests. Alright, what is over here? Let's touch the poochies. Give the poochies the patsies and then speak to her. The dogs need the rest as do I. Oh, that's a spelling mistake right there. So do you think we'll be back to Dragonblight? And do you think the shrines are the keys to giving the powers back to the aspects? No. No, if anything, the shrines would have been built because they didn't have access to the Dragon Isles. So I highly doubt that we would need the shrines. Okay, I don't know what I'm supposed to do to get things off the boats, though. Dr. Nutley. Aha, Mr. Templeton. I trust all is going well. Well as can be. It was good to see Mr. Hammond make his recovery. All thanks to your expertise, I take it. I tried my best. You should continue to do so.
Kasha is inside his tank now. Okay. That photographer, Balfod? What about her? Did she come snooping around your tent as well? I caught her prying a couple of times. I can guess she found nothing on you? No, she did not. We could all learn something from you, Tashi.
What are they hiding?
Let's see. Evening, sure. I've been thinking about our pay once we return to land safely. Har, don't mistake me for the avaricious sort. But I do have expenses to pay. Before we departed, I received a letter from one of my daughters asking to cover cost of her stage school. I would be ashamed to promise a luxury only to retract it, don't you think? Do you not have enough money left over from your films? I wasn't aware you had a daughter, Kurt.
If the assass would have guessed.
Yeah, but what is Lefty hiding?
I wasn't aware you had a daughter, Kurt.
Two, in fact. Both with the first wife.
Right. I think we've spoken to everyone now.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Evening. Fuck. All right. Minus one available crew. Wait, did one of my crew get hurt? Harold Turner has food poisoning. Fuck me. Harold Turner has food poisoning. Well, this is fucking great. How do I send Harold Turner? Ah, doctor, how are you holding? Still finding yourself with bouts of sickness? No, that isn't a problem. It was only seasickness. Now that we're no longer at sea, my stomach is settled. For the most part. If you ever feel the queasiness set in once more, I learned an old trick in my travels. Simply close your eyes and count backwards from 10. It worked me a treat in my youth. Right, I'll try that. I'm guessing. Let's see if we can get a little bit of coal into this, your furnace. Right, furnace is full. Happy days for everyone. Leave. Here we go. The ship is gonna sink now, isn't it?
Yep.
Continue to watch. Bah! Here goes our ship. Dude, how am I gonna get any decorum back as a result of this shit? She's gone. And that's the end of the demo, ladies and gentlemen. That's the end of the demo. This is very cool. I fucking loved this. This was such a good game. I mean, we made it off. We lost no one. No one died. We made it to week 8. The funny thing is, Teddy Bread, how you doing, bro? Build a new ship with hookers and blackjack? I'm getting on that. The funny thing is, you have to do this for 42 weeks. And it was already towards the end becoming quite the discussion of what do we do, because you can't do everything. This is a very, very good game. I will say, not exactly, I think, a great stream game. Like, I think
once the game launches, I will probably not stream it. Just because it is the kind of game that you want to play it. You want to see the actual story, but that can change, right? Make some beef jerky. I look forward to watching you play the whole thing. If people want me to play the whole thing, I will absolutely do it. But it is phenomenal. This game is absolutely brilliant. It's so much fucking fun playing this. I didn't think I would, but... Decision, you'd have a 12-hour stream for week one? I mean, you could do... This could very easily be one of those games where if you do enough work, you could do the stream control everything. Or take care of yourself, bro. Thanks so much for hanging out, man. Really appreciate it. Like, the stream makes the decisions. You could absolutely have that. And I'm pretty sure there's mods like that. If me and Alex looked around a bit, I'm pretty sure you do get mods out there that allow that. Like, it will track the decisions that people are making. And based on those decisions, it will tell me what the outcome should be. But very, very, very good game. All in all, how did you guys find it? Did you enjoy it? Tunnel Knight, yeah. I think if you did something like that, if you did it like really fucking sort of interactive, I think it could be really fun. Marvelous, World Gate. How many of you, after watching this, is like, yeah, I need to get this? For a live stream, Random Age, very happy to have you here, brother. Enjoyed it. I feel relaxed now. Tuned in late, but yes, looked great. It would be cool to do as a group, but then we couldn't laugh at you for killing the crew. Well, yeah, but it would still be a group thing, right? Very much my kind of game. I love this. And I would love to see what happens next. Like, because things are about, I think, to heat the fuck up. I'm just sad that I didn't know how to rescue things from the boat by the time that I should have rescued it from the boat. It's a little bit sad, though. Kind of a game that keeps you playing because you want to see what happens. Absolutely. Very, very fucking cool.